There's certain core values that I think we have to all buy into totally, and the first one is faith. You have to believe in something bigger than yourself to be a great football team.
Cross your fingers, say a silent prayer for Al Delgreco.
Attitude is how we talk to ourselves.
To the 15, 10, go crazy, Cadillac, go crazy!
Mental toughness, we must have it. It's the secret sauce.
Hicks steps up, he throws to Williams. He's got it! Touchdown, Auburn!
Integrity is not always getting it right, or none of us would have it. It's really when you don't get it right, what do you do?
Howard wants to throw. Howard fires. Pass is tipped around. It's intercepted at the 40, the 35, the 30, the 20, the 10. He's gone! Robinson, touchdown!
Love is the next core value. It's the ability to handle inconveniences that come with relationships.
Gamble in the end zone.
The last is why, which is you. We need the fans. We need the Auburn family.
The atmosphere, the crowd, the roar.
That's what's special about this place. What's special about the Auburn family.
Auburn's going to go very long. Four Beasley. Nobody's going to get it. Oh, Jackson! Auburn!
Up the middle, up and over. And Cam Mason. He is good.
The kick is good. Auburn wins!
Out of the gun. Play action. They throw. Wide open. Touchdown!
Auburn has come to the West Coast for the latest starting time in school history. The Tigers departed a day early to get accustomed to life on the West Coast, and now it's time to go hunting for bears. Good evening and War Eagle from California Memorial Stadium with Jason Campbell, Will Herring, Paul Ellen, Brad Law, Gene Dulaney, Patrick Tisdale, and Ben Arling. I'm Andy Burcham. The Hugh Freeze era opened with a bang last week. The Tigers dismantled UMass in front of the largest crowd at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Auburn rushed for 289 yards, threw for another 203. Damari Alston, Jeremiah Cobb, Sean Jackson, and Robbie Ashford all scored on the ground. Ashford scored three times in the first half. The Tigers forced three turnovers, two by Jalen Simpson, including a 50-yard pick six. Cal went on the road for its season opener, racking up 669 yards of total offense. In a 58-21 win at North Texas, backup quarterback Ben Finley was 24 of 34 for 279 yards and a touchdown. Freshman All-American Jade Knott opened his sophomore season with 188 yards and a pair of touchdowns. Auburn is out to make history tonight. The Tigers have never won in the Golden State. Time to snap that three-game losing streak against a team that will be coming east frequently when it joins the ACC next year. The Outdoor Alabama countdown to kickoff continues in a moment.
It's game day. What do you take to the tailgate? A flat screen TV? Take it to the tailgate. Your wife's favorite blender? The DJ sound system? With a Ford F-150 truck, you can take it all. With available Pro Power onboard that acts like a mobile generator, you can use F-150 to take your tailgate to the next level. Visit your local Ford dealer today. The Auburn Tigers and Ford F-150. Greatness starts here. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
Hey y'all, this is Ronte, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the pimento cheese. I was like, go cheese, go pimento, go honey, go get it.
Hi, this is Chantreese, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the mild spiciness of the pickled jalapenos. No, it's the crispy chicken. Actually, I can't decide. It's the entire sandwich.
Order the honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Available for a limited time. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonials.
When we say we're an everything school, we mean it. Auburn University isn't just home to the best athletics program in the nation. It's also home to the best student-centered engineering experience in America. And that's not just a slogan. It's a promise. The Samuel Ginn College of Engineering ranks as the top engineering college in the state of Alabama, while also ranking as one of the best public engineering colleges in the nation. Tomorrow's leaders, innovators, and world changers begin at the Ginn College of Engineering. Visit today, eng.auburn.edu.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical. You always say vibrantly tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
You're listening to Auburn Football. Now back to more of the Outdoor Alabama Countdown to Kickoff. Visit OutdoorAlabama.com to find your next adventure. Go hunt. Go fish. Get outdoors.
Welcome back to Berkeley, California, California Memorial Stadium, celebrating its 100th year of existence. Welcome back to Auburn Football. The Tigers getting ready to face the Cal Golden Bears. Along with Jason Campbell, I'm Andy Bershaw. At Auburn's College of Veterinary Medicine, biomedical scientists and veterinarians train alongside leading faculty researchers and clinicians in one of the nation's most advanced teaching hospitals and cutting-edge research facilities. Learn more at vetmed.auburn.edu. Well, Auburn will have Jarquez Hunter tonight. It gives Auburn another wrinkle, Jason, in what has become a very good rushing attack for the Tigers.
Yeah, getting Jarquez back just adds another dimension to this offense. You know, we were already a fast-paced offense, and Coach Freeze and Coach Montgomery wants to create a physical-style offense as well. People think when you run the no-huddle that it's more passing. Well, not in this offense. This offense is built around the run game, around our starting five offensive linemen up front getting some push. You add Jarquez to a great group from last week, and I don't know what our defense is going to do to stop our run, because I'm sure he can't wait to touch that football. It's going to be like lightning in a bottle.
This is the first time that Auburn and Cal have met in football. Cal, the 88th team of 133 current FBS members that Auburn has played, and the Tigers and the Bears get ready here tonight. Well, we talked about the Auburn running attack. This Cal running attack is just as potent as the Tigers.
Oh, most definitely. There's their star, Jordan, you know, the starting running back for them, had 188 yards and two rushing touchdowns last week. And then his follow-up, Ifunze, had three rushing touchdowns last week. So Cal likes to run the football as well. They had over 300 yards rushing last week. So this is a team that likes to play physical as well. They're well-balanced. They had over 300 yards passing. So this is an offense that's well-balanced. Auburn has got to play key defense tonight and make sure we hold them down and neutralize their run game.
And Auburn has had to prepare for two different quarterbacks, two different style of quarterbacks, much like Cal does with Auburn. Sam Jackson V, a transfer from TCU, uses the legs more often than he does pass it. On the other hand, Ben Finley, who played primarily from about the second quarter on last week at North Texas and was 24 of 34, a transfer from North Carolina State, more of the simple dropback passer.
It's almost like the opposite of Auburn, right? So
right.
You take from Sam Jackson, if he's a starter, then he's a 4-3, 4-4 guy. Now, this is a small tidbit, but he actually played high school with Peyton Thorne as his receiver in high school at Naperville Central.
So they're very good friends.
So they're very good friends. They're well-connected. And then you look at Ben Finley. You know, this guy came in, had a 7% completion percentage last week against North Texas. Also, if you look at Peyton Thorne, he's a guy that wants to get his passing game going. So for Auburn, and Robbie Ashford kind of reminds you of a Sam Jackson. He's a guy that likes to run first, but he's trying to develop as a passer. So two similar offenses, two similar quarterback situations. Let's see what happens tonight.
Peyton Thorne and Sam Jackson have an active texting back and forth, but apparently they text at the start of the week and said, that's it for the week. We're playing each other. We'll talk about it next week.
Yeah, you have to do that sometimes with your friends. You got to let them know, hey, this is business first. You know, no offense, but somebody's going to be paying for dinner after this one, Andy.
Great things are possible when you have the power, performance, and smart features of a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Greatness starts at your local Ford dealer. Jason, what are your Ford keys for tonight's game?
Yeah, number one for me is start fast. Do the same thing you did last week against UMass. You found a way to get points on the board on your first drive. You have to do that in an environment like this. Number two, we did very well last week protecting the football. You cannot turn the football over in a hostile environment on the road. You got to try to keep that ball to your hands. Number three, neutralize their run game and their explosive plays. They like to get explosive plays. We got to do a good job of neutralizing that. And number four for me, can our receivers get open on third downs, because we're going to need them tonight to sustain drives.
Let me go to number three. How do you neutralize a very, very good run game?
I think you do a lot what you did last week. I think you get involved with your star players on defense as far as Keontae Scott and Donovan Kaufman. Both turnovers happened from those guys playing a nickel position. Coach Roberts brought them on blitzes and got them involved in stopping the run and also creating negative plays for the UMass offense.
Wouldn't you also agree that Auburn's defensive line has to do a better job of shedding blocks here tonight?
Yeah, that's a key. Coach Freeze talked about it last week after the game. Hey, we got to do a better job of getting off blocks and do a better job of playing assignment football. You mentioned it earlier, Andy, that Coach Freeze said we was misaligned 15 times.
Right.
You cannot afford to be misaligned that many times against an opponent like California tonight. So we got to make sure we play assignment football, and I look for us to do that. We're short at one linebacker, so hopefully Eugene Suntec can come in and fill that spot.
Yeah, Austin Keys is done for a while, had surgery on a thumb. He is done indefinitely. We just don't know when he will possibly be back for Auburn this year. And one more thing, Auburn has to contend with a hostile crowd for the first time this season.
Yeah, it's got transfer portal. This is where the transfer portal last week. We're at home. It helps us from an offensive line standpoint. We have four starters on the offensive line that are transfer guys. Didn't have to deal with a lot of crowd noise. Tonight, we have to deal with a lot of crowd noise, so it'll be important for us not to get those false starts, not to get too antsy. Make sure that we hold our water and sit in there.
And if Cal does get off to a good start, you can't lose your composure in a game like this one tonight.
No, most definitely. This is a four-quarter game. It's a marathon, not a race. You got to continue to just stay patient. Don't get over-anxious. If they hit a big play, just go back, resettle. Everyone calm down and stay aggressive. I say offensively for us tonight, we need to stay aggressive.
Auburn and Cal, the Tigers and the Golden Bears. Stay tuned for kickoff. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
Jairus McIntyre, former Auburn wide receiver.
I think Auburn was the best decision for myself. He grew up in Alabama, played for Auburn, and I watched Auburn growing up. And deep down, I felt like I always wanted to go to Auburn. It was a dream of mine, but he never really pushed it on me. Miami, I was close. It was kind of came down to Auburn, Miami, Florida, a couple other schools wanted to play safety, different positions. But I just think deep down, you know, it was Auburn for me. I think I always knew I wanted to go there. I'm glad I did. It was a really good time there and met a lot of great people.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
Adventure is waiting for you at Alabama State Parks. So, pack your bags. With so much to explore, there's something for everybody. Whether you're hiking the foothills of the Appalachians or wading into the warm waters of the Gulf, finding a vacation that you and your family will love comes naturally at any one of our Alabama State Parks. To learn more, call 800-ALAPARK or visit alapark.com. This message brought to you by your Alabama State Parks.
This is Auburn Football. And these are the Yellowwoods starting lineups for the Tigers. Defensive line.
Jason Jones, Clear, Alabama, Clear High School.
Marcus Harris, Montgomery, Alabama, Park Crossing High School.
Masai Nasiri Kita, Pittsburgh, California, Northgate High School.
Linebackers.
Elijah McAllister, Asbury Park, New Jersey, Rumson Fairhaven Regional High School.
Eugene Asante, Alexandria, Virginia, Westfield High School.
Cam Riley, Evergreen, Alabama, Hillcrest High School.
Secondary.
DJ James, Mobile, Alabama, Spanish Fort High School.
Nehemiah Preach, Jackson, Alabama, Jackson High School.
Zion Prickett, Griffin, Georgia, Sparta High School.
DJ James, Mobile, Alabama, Spanish Fort High School.
Keontae Scott, San Diego, California, Helix High School.
Offensive line.
Dylan Wade, Houston, Texas, South Falls.
Jeremiah Wright, Selma High School, Selma, Alabama.
Avery Jones, Havelock, North Carolina, Havelock High School.
Cam Stutz, Killen, Alabama, Brooks High School.
Gunnar Britton, Conway, South Carolina, Conway High School.
Receivers.
Rivaldo Ferrader, Lauderdale, Florida, Boyd Anderson High School.
Shane Hollywood Hooks, West Orlando, Florida, Olympia High School.
Jay Fair, Dallas, Texas, Rockwall Heath High School.
Jair Shorter, Killeen, Texas, Ellison High School.
Running back.
Jamari Austin, Atlanta, Georgia, Woodward Academy.
Quarterback.
Peyton Thorne, Naperville, Illinois, Naperville Central High School.
Special teams.
Reed Hughes, Conway, Arkansas, Conway High School.
Oscar Chapman, Adelaide, South Australia, Prince Alfred College.
Alex McPherson, Fort Payne, Alabama, Fort Payne High School.
The starting lineups have been presented by Great Southern Wood, makers of Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it. This is the Outdoor Alabama Countdown to Kickoff on the Auburn Sports Network. Here's Paul Ellen to break down the matchups from Berkeley.
Welcome back to Cal Memorial Stadium. Bit of a late arriving crowd here tonight. Lots of orange and blue in the stands. We expect to see a lot of gold in the stands here tonight as this is the home opener for Cal. They're celebrating 100 years at this venerable stadium. Auburn and Cal tonight. We're waiting both teams to come out on the field. The Tigers coming out, well, actually just to the right of Auburn's bench on the west side of the stands. Cal to come out of the north end zone, and they're about to come out onto the field tonight. Game day weather forecast is presented by Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Celebrate responsibly. It is a gorgeous 68 degrees, low humidity, clear skies overhead. Now listen, Jason, you played in this area a couple years in Oakland. Is this what you typically expected this time of year here in Northern California?
Oh, this is a break for Auburn. We've been down in the south where it's been hot and humid, and now we get a chance to come out to the west coast where this is beautiful weather. You couldn't ask for better weather for a night for a football game. It's going to be in the mid-50s, probably 60 degrees, but at the same time, it's a different kind of weather too, Andy. It can be a little dry, so as a quarterback, you have to make sure your towel has a little bit of moisture on it. I always put water on my towel just to kind of wet my hands a little bit because your hands get really slippery and dry in this type of weather.
I can't believe the hands as big as that you had trouble gripping a football in your career.
Hey, you know, you're either going to have ashy hands or you're going to have some moisturizer. Okay. So in this type of weather, I had to go with the moisturizer.
All right. We await the coin flip tonight, see which team goes on offense first tonight. Both of these teams, I thought, learned a lot about their squad a week ago because both of these teams have relied heavily on the transfer portal. Cal even more so than Auburn this year.
Yeah, Cal has over 52 new players from transfer and signees, and Auburn had 42. So both of these teams look totally different than they did a year ago. This is a game, Andy, where you come out, you learn your most in football from week one to week two. We'll see what Auburn can do more tonight than last week. And same thing with Cal. Cal played a North Texas team last week. They will learn more about their program as well.
All right, we'll send it down to the field. Our Will Herring with a special guest on the sideline here.
What's up, guys? I bumped into a stranger, Coach Bruce Pearl here. Bruce, talk about the Auburn family. We were just commenting on earlier. Just they showed up big, didn't they?
This is Auburn being Auburn. That's all this is right here, and it's amazing. Coach Freeze and his coaching staff and these kids have given the Auburn family hope. What happened at UMass was unbelievable. Record-setting. So proud of our student body. And these kids appreciate it. I think our players really appreciate it. And I know they're going to play hard all night.
Amen, Coach. Thank you for visiting with us.
All right, War Eagle.
All right, War Eagle.
All right, Will Herring with Auburn's Bruce Pearl. He, Bruce, and about 9,000 more out here tonight. Now, we understand there's a big number of the folks from Northern California. The Northern California Auburn clubs are here tonight. I've seen on social media tons of folks that have been out taking part in Napa Valley. Jason, you did that. And some folks even drove here as well. So folks have been preparing for this. They've played Pebble Beach. They've played Spyglass Hill. So this has been a big trip, and it caps off with this one tonight.
Oh, yeah, this is a trip that Auburn fans have been looking for. As soon as they saw it on the schedule, people came out early. Three-fourths of the people that was on our flight from Atlanta to here on Thursday was Auburn people. Auburn loves to travel. They show up. They support their students. And this is a great atmosphere tonight. We even got people hanging up in the hills above the stadium with the Bears tonight. So, you know, Auburn's got a lot to fight against them tonight. But I expect Auburn to come out tonight and play like the Auburn football team that we so desire. Physical, fast, and explosive.
Auburn's captains have gathered at midfield. They're about to go out for the coin flip. We'll have that for you. Cal's 58 points last week at North Texas are the most in a season opener since scoring 73 against Grambling in 2015. You got to say that Cal answered a lot of questions last week with all of the transfers that they have.
Oh, yeah, that's why you go into the transfer portal. You can turn around your program now within a year or two rather than having to wait 7 years to try to develop your team. The transfer portal works for both of these teams. It's giving Auburn a great experience at offensive line and defensive line. Tigers are getting ready to come out right now. You can hear the Auburn crowd. This is about to be an exciting game, man. You can't wait.
The Auburn marching band, a small marching band, is here just to the opposite side of the sideline here. In addition, a mass of the Auburn fans in orange and blue right behind the band. But there is orange and blue all around this stadium here tonight.
Yes, Auburn is well represented. I don't know if Cal sold half their tickets to us, but I do say this. Auburn has showed up and showed out. And no matter how you got here or where you come from, the Auburn family is here.
We understand that Auburn's bought all of the 5,000 tickets allotted by Cal through the Auburn ticket office, but there's probably 6,000-7,000 more tickets that have been sold, folks in their orange and blue here tonight to make some noise for the Auburn Tigers. Auburn's captains are making their way onto the field. Elijah McAllister, Luke Deal, quarterback Peyton Thorne, and Cam Stutz. The Auburn quarterback, or the Auburn captains, and they're in single file as they head to midfield for the coin toss tonight. Daniel Gautreau is the referee, and he will toss this one up. Auburn in the all-white tops and bottoms and Stormtroopers with, of course, the white helmet and white face masks here tonight. We'll send it down for the coin toss presented by Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one.
Pulley. Guys, this side is heads, this side is tails. Auburn, you were the visitors. What is your call?
Heads.
The call is heads. It is tails. Which way would you like to kick? All right, switch sides.
So Cal wins the toss. We'll defer to the second half. So Auburn goes on offense. The Tigers will defend the south goal, which is where a large portion of the Auburn fans are here tonight. So Auburn on offense. Let's talk about some keys early on for the Tigers and primarily for Peyton Thorne at the quarterback spot tonight.
Yeah, this is great for Auburn to receive the ball first when you're on the road. The one thing you want to do as an offense is try to take the opponent's home crowd out of it. How you do that? You go fast on offense, you get explosive plays, but you sustain drives. And I think the most important thing for Peyton tonight is to make sure that everyone's getting off the snap on time. Make sure that there's chemistry. Make sure things are flowing properly, because we are in an opponent's territory. So we have to make sure first that we're not first and 15, second and 15. So make sure we're moving the ball and moving the chains forward.
Both of these teams like to go fast on offense, a fast pace. How important, with that in mind, then, is time of possession here tonight? Here's my example. Last week in the third quarter, Auburn had the ball for 2 minutes and 7 seconds, but scored three times, one on a pick six and another on a first play from scrimmage. But then in the fourth quarter, Auburn controlled the fourth quarter and had the ball for nearly 13 minutes.
And I think a lot of that, Andy, is when both teams are running explosive offense where they like to go fast, defense is the key. Our defense last week, what they did, the first drive, UMass scored. But after that, you saw Coach Roberts make some changes. He got the nickel guys more involved in the run game. He got more blitzes involved. The reason you go fast on offense is to eliminate the defense opponent's blitzes and top plays. So we'll see which team tonight is able to sustain drives and which defense is going to show up and slow down the opponent's offense.
Already a difference in Auburn's return game with both Jarquez Hunter and Brian Batty at the goal line. Remember last week, Batty was the only deep man for Auburn.
Yes, and Batty is not afraid to take that ball 5 yards out of the end zone. So he's explosive. He's excited about this game. So I look for him to have a big return game tonight.
Michael Luckhurst, the son of the former Falcons kicker Mick Luckhurst, will kick it off for Cal, and we are underway. End over end to the end zone. Battee, 4 yards deep, will bring it out to the 10. He's to the 15. He's across the 20 and taken down at the 23-yard line.
Yeah, great run by Battee to take that ball out of the end zone. Like we just said, he's not afraid to do that. He's one tackle away right there for probably springing it for another 20, 25 yards.
Down, football down at the 22-yard line. Auburn's offensive line, Avery Jones at center. Cam Stutz and Gunnar Britton at the guards with Dylan Wade and Isavion Tutal-Miller at the tackles. Omari Kelly opens up at a wide receiver spot along with Shane Hooks and Jay Fair. Ball in the middle of the field, Thorne from the shotgun. On first down and 10, Jarquez Hunter tries to bounce to the outside, gets upfield, and carries the pile 3 yards to just shy of the 25-yard line.
And see, Coach Montgomery wants to get Jarquez involved in the game early and often get him some touches as quick as he can.
Second and 7 for Auburn. Back to the ball. It is Hunter. Hunter off the right side gets 3 more yards. He is out to the 28. And it will be 3rd down and a long 3, make that a long 4 for the Tigers. 3rd and 4 for Auburn. A week ago on 3rd down, Auburn was 60%. Jarquez goes out of the backfield in motion and lines up at the wide receiver spot on the right side. So 3 to the left, double wide receivers right, an empty backfield for Peyton Thorne. Play clock at 12. There's the snap. Thorne drops to throw, flushed out of the pocket, looks, gets to the sideline, Thorne up the sideline, fumbled the ball ahead, it's picked up by Cal, it's going to be a touchdown for Cal.
I think this one might be coming back, Andy. I think Thorne stepped out of bounds at the 30.
Did Thorne go out of bounds before he fumbled it?
Yeah, I think Thorne stepped on the line before fumbling the ball forward, so this may benefit Auburn here.
That would be an enormous break for the Tigers because the fumble was returned for a touchdown.
It looked like they was trying to throw a hitch to Jarquez. Bears playing man defense there. And great coverage by the Bears defense. Thorne couldn't find anyone, got outside the pocket. But fortunate enough,
the ruling
for
on the field is the runner was out of bounds prior to the ball coming loose. The previous play is under video review.
Thorne was flushed out of the pocket. He had one man to beat. He got to the sideline. And according to the play, went out of bounds at the 29-yard line. Review or replay reviews are brought to you by Auburn's Houston Clinic. Don't let a sport injury bench you this season. Go to Houston for your fracture, sprain, or strain. Because orthopedics is all they do. Go straight to the specialist. Go to Auburn's Houston Clinic. When he fumbled it, apparently he was out of bounds, although they're reviewing this right now. But he fumbled it forward. It was caught in the air and returned by Jackson Sermon for a touchdown.
And the thing about this, though, Andy, the play on the field was called he stepped out of bounds. So there would have to be exclusive evidence in order to overturn this call. I thought his left foot touched out of bounds before the ball coming out. Watching the film here, it looks simultaneous. We'll see what happens on this call.
Well, Auburn is hoping that it gets to punt right now. Here's Paul Allen with a check to the Yellowwood scoreboard.
Quick update. Texas has beaten Alabama 34-24 in Tuscaloosa, rolled up 454 yards and dominated the fourth quarter. So a bit of an upset for the soon-to-be SEC Longhorns. Andy?
And the Southeastern Conference is still looking for its first win against a Power 5 non-conference team this season.
Yeah, it's been tough sledding these first 2 weeks for the SEC.
The replay continues on the Auburn sideline, just inside the 15-yard line. And I'm guessing this is a Pac-12 crew because they're actually looking at a monitor. If it were an SEC crew, they would be talking directly with no monitor to the SEC office, or is it? It is an SEC crew, we understand. All right.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting call because you have to see clearly evidence to overturn this call.
Here is Daniel Gautreau with the call.
After video review, the call has been overturned to a fumble, recovered by Cal at the 35-yard line. It'll be 1st and 10, Cal.
Yeah, since the play was blown dead when Thorne was thought to be out of bounds. It is not a return for a touchdown by Sermon. It is simply a fumble recovery by Sermon. And Cal gets the ball at the 35. That's Auburn's first turnover of the season.
Yeah, something we talked about pregame, something Auburn didn't do last week was turn the ball over at home against UMass. First turnover in the first drive of the game. Now we got to see what our defense can do against sudden change.
And let's see who comes out to run quarterback for Cal. Is it number 5, Sam Jackson, the fifth, or number 10, Ben Finley?
They're going to get Ben Finley.
Finley, the quarterback. First and 10 for Cal. From the Auburn 35-yard line, ball in the middle of the field. Finley works out of the shotgun. Brings a man in motion. There's the snap. The handoff it's a play action. Up the sideline, down the sideline, and incomplete. Intended for Brian Hightower with coverage for Kyan Lee.
Yes, great coverage by a freshman, Kyan Lee, filling in for Nehemiah Pritchett. He's not afraid to get up in the face of the offensive receiver. Great play right there by Kyan Lee not to get the flag.
Play action to Ott. They went with single coverage down the side. A nice play by Lee, a freshman out of Ellenwood, Georgia, who got the start last week for the injured Nehemiah Pritchett at cornerback. They're second and 10 from the Auburn 35. Again, a man in motion. This time the handoff goes to Ott. Ott stood up inside the 35-yard line for a 3-yard gain. And it brings up third down and a 7 for Cal.
Yes, Ott is definitely a running back that you want to stop before he gets going. He's explosive and very quick as a running back. Big third down for Auburn here.
Elijah McAllister getting off the bottom of that pile for Auburn. So, third down and a 7 a week ago. Cal was 50% on third down in its win at North Texas. Double wide receivers right and left for the Bears. Ott in motion to the Auburn boundary. The throw to the sideline. It is caught and maybe a yard shy, make that 2 yards shy of the first down.
Yes, big tackle by Elijah McAllister coming inside out right there. Keontae Scott was on the coverage, slipped a little bit, missed his tackle, but credit the hustle to Elijah McAllister right there.
Fourth down, a yard and a half for Cal. And the Bears line up, they're going to go for it. Cal a week ago, 3 of 3 on third down. Ott, the tailback, flanks Finley to his left. Hand off Ott. First down and more. Ott to the 23-yard line and a first down for Cal.
Yeah, that's a big conversion for Cal right there. Auburn defense needed that stop to try to hold his offense, make that turnover less of a hard time.
3 yards and a first down for Ott, following Cindric Driscoll and Vodakonin, the middle three of that Cal offensive line. First down from the 23. They pitch it. The ball is crumbled in the backfield. All kinds of trouble. And down at the 34 goes number 14, Moreau Young. He was coming on an end around, but he never got the pitch from Finley.
Yes, Cal with a self-inflicted wound right there, but benefit Auburn defense getting back there and getting that tackle. But what a bad play by Cal right there.
A loss of 11 for Cal. Back to the 33-yard line, left hash mark. Trips to the wide side of the field. That's the Auburn boundary. Finley out of the shotgun. Drops now, rolls to the Auburn boundary. He looks and he throws to the Auburn boundary. And it's out of bounds to Monroe. Taken down by Keontae Scott. They get the 11 yards back. And it brings up second, make that third down and 10 for the Cal Golden Bears.
Yeah, that's a play for Cal where they want to get half of it back to create a manageable third down there. Great sprint right pass with the comeback to the outside receiver.
Hightower comes in and replaces Asher Alberding, a tight end. And Hightower goes wide right, double wide right to the short side of the field. Jeremiah Hunter at the top of the formation. Hunter goes in motion. Third and 10 for the Bears. Finley looks, he floats it. It's complete to Ott. He's run down from behind by Eugene Asante. A gain of 1 on the play. Asante ran down Jaden Ott.
That's something we talked about pregame. Asante can run east and west. He's fast. He's not a big physical linebacker that's going to blow you with the eyes, but this guy can run sideline to sideline. He showed you exceptional speed right there on that third down. Big stop for Auburn. That's a win for this defense and this team.
This will be a field goal of just under 40 yards for Luckhurst, who was 1 of 3 last week and 0 of 1 from this distance. The holder is Lachlan Wilson, the punter. Snap down. The kick is on the way by Luckhurst, and he made it.
Oh, they got away with one right there. I thought they were right. I thought they were right in on the field goal. Block team hooked our guy. They did not call that. If you watch it on the TV, it said you have got to see this. They missed the right side call here of hooking our blocker.
3-0. Cal leads it. 9:42 to go in the first quarter of play. Stay tuned. Auburn football continues in a moment.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever?
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any sports fan. So make sure you... Wait, Jim, I didn't mean try it right now. We're still on the air.
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
Really?
No, not right now, Jen. We got a game to call.
When the game goes into overtime. But the game goes into overtime. The choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Nobody protects you from mayhem like Allstate. I'm your friend's lucky jersey that's never been washed. And I'm stanking up the back seat, overpowering all of your senses, so you don't see the brake lights up ahead. And if you have cut-rate car insurance, you're going to be all out of luck. So switch to Allstate. Save $468 and get better protected from mayhem, like me.
National average annual savings of new auto customers surveyed in 2022 who switched to Allstate. In most states, prices vary based on how you buy. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Allstate Fire and Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates, Northbrook, Illinois.
Three nothing. Cal leads it. 9:42 to go in the first quarter of play. 13 yards, 8 plays, 3 minutes, 51 seconds. The drive for Cal after the fumble. Let's send it downstairs. Will Herring has a Cook's Pest Control sideline reports.
Guys, we talked about it in pregame. We're going to have some guys step up on defense. Kay and Lee on the outside are true freshmen. They showed up front first play of the game. They went deep on Kyan. He, tremendous play, staying in phase, looking back, making a play on the ball. Another guy, Eugene Asante. We're down a linebacker. Austin Keys is out. Eugene had a good play over there in space, ran down probably their best player on the team, and just made a great play in space.
All right, well, thank you. Luckhurst out to kick it away. With Jarquez and Batie. And it's Batie 2 yards deep in the end zone, brings it forward. Now bounces to the outside. And Batie is taken down at the 11, and a flag is down in the play. A flag thrown near the tackle.
That's the danger about taking that ball out of the end zone so deep sometimes. I like the aggressiveness, but sometimes you just have to say uncle.
We wait for the call from Daniel
Gotro.
During
the return, holding, receiving team number 8, half the distance to the goal from the spot of the foul, first down.
So the Tigers are backed up even more, back to the 6-yard line. Austin Osbury, backup linebacker, called for a hold. Here's Auburn's second offensive drive. The Tigers fumbled on the opening drive.
It's our first time this year to have to see Auburn go the distance here. We've got to go 95 yards to get a score here.
First down from just inside the right hash mark at the Auburn 6. Handoff up the middle. 2 yard gain on the play. Off the right side. Jarquez Hunter for 2 more yards for the Tigers. Second down and 8. Auburn right back to the line of scrimmage. Second down and 8 from the 8 yard line. Trips to the wide side of the field, including tight end Brandon Frazier. Handoff goes to Jarquez. Jarquez to the 10. The pile moves him forward, but he is blown dead at the 10-yard line.
Yeah, Auburn trying to run behind that right offensive side of the line. They're trying to go behind our right side over there because our guys right now just looking like we need to sustain this drive here, Andy. This is not something you want to get backed up and be punting out of your own end zone.
Shane Hooks in the game this year, now wearing number 3. Along with Jay Fair, splits wide right. Jair Shorter into the ball game as well. Splitting wide left. Third and 6. Thorne to throw. Taken down at the 2-yard line.
Yeah, we struggled right there in pass protection. Thorne got sacked on the 2-yard line. Definitely kicking the ball back in the end zone. This is not the start that we were looking for coming on the road. I know it's a late game for Auburn, but we need to start faster than this. We just got to regroup and settle down here.
Ricky Correa, junior from Fresno, with the sack. And Oscar Chapman will punt it. And he stands about a yard inside the back line of the Auburn end zone. The snapper is Jacob Quattlebaum. Chapman gets it away, high end over end, and a fair catch at the 33-yard line. And again, a short field for Cal, a 32-yard punt. First and 10 for the Bears at the Auburn 33 when we come back. 7:36 to go in the first quarter. Cal on top, 3-0. We'll keep it here. Finley back at quarterback. Jaden Ott is the tailback. Wide receivers, double wide receivers right and left for the Golden Bears. Cal on top 3-0, 7:36 to go in the first quarter of play. Finley from the shotgun. Hands the ball to Ott. Jaden Ott carries the pile down to the Auburn 27-yard line.
Yes, right there. It's a great job by a young guy getting in there and making that tackle.
6 yard gain for Jaden Ott, freshman All-American last year, over 1,000 yards in his brief Cal career. Second and 4. Ott again with some room, gets to the 25, falls forward inside the 25 yard line to the 24 and a half.
Yeah,
he gets 2 more yards on the play.
Looked like Cam Riley was in on that tackle there, Andy. The play before that, Keldrick Fault did a good job. The young freshman, the talented freshman, is in the game as well.
Third and 1.5 yards, a long yard for Cal. Back to the line of scrimmage, left hash mark. Tight end comes in motion across the play. Ott to run it. Ott has the first down. He's at the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 4 for Jaden Ott up the middle. First down for the Cal Bears.
Cal is standing these manageable short and third down and short situations, which is very manageable. It gives you the run-pass option. Keeping Auburn defense on their heels.
Wide side of the field to the Auburn boundary. A single receiver there, and that is Hightower. Now man in motion near side. Roll by Finley. Looks back across the grain. He throws it. It's complete to Ott with a flag on the play. Ott goes out of bounds at the 10, but this may come back.
You're going to get a holding by Cal here.
Thorne rolled holding. Right.
Offense, number 60. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
Got the left guard Driscoll. He rolled out of the right and then looked back across the grain for Ott out of the backfield, and Driscoll was called for the hold.
Yeah, he definitely had Ott out of the backfield there. He ran a little running back sneak out of the backside and lost that linebacker there, but we got fortunate there that they got a hold.
Jake Spavital, the new offensive coordinator, quarterback coach at A&M with Johnny Manziel back in 2013. What does he dial up on first and 20 from the Auburn 30? Play action. They throw to the boundary. The pass is complete and out of bounds to the 25 to Jeremiah Hunter, taken out of bounds by DJ James.
Yes, Hunter is their feature receiver that they like to throw to a lot. Good job by DJ by not giving too much cushion there.
Hunter had 6 catches for 64 yards a week ago, a second team all Pac-12 player. Second and 15. Hand off to the near side. It is down to the 20. They hand it off to Monroe Young on the carry. Mosiah Nasili-Kite with the stop for Auburn. It's third and 10.
Yeah, Mosiah from that backside running and making a tackle across the field. Great hustle there.
Transfer out of Maryland, originally out of Pittsburgh. Third and 10 for Cal from the right hash mark. That's the Auburn side. Double wide receivers right and left for Brian Finley. Auburn rushes 5. And Finley's taken down at the 25. Right up the middle, number 50, Marcus Harris gets to Finley. It's a 5-yard sack back to the 25-yard line.
I love the play call by Coach Roberts' defense there. Showed a 2-shell at the snap and then also rolled down to man coverage and brought the inside blitz. And Marcus Harris was able to beat his guy up front and be credited with the sack.
Did he twist up front, Jason?
I think he did a little something. I think he twisted. That's Marcus Harris' game. He's very quick off the ball. He's not a tall guy like Jason Jones, but he beats you with his quickness.
Michael Luckhurst with a 42-yard field goal attempt just inside the right hash. The snapper is David Byrd. It's a good snap. Auburn almost gets to it. Luckhurst's kick is away, and he missed it. Wide right.
That was created by Jalen Simpson again off the edge. He was held the first time, Andy, that they kicked the field goal, and Coach Freeze was livid. He got no call for a hole, but here he forced that ball to be missed and pushed wide. Great job by Jalen coming off the edge right there.
4:09 in the first quarter. Cal, despite great field position, comes up empty. Bears lead it 3-0. Auburn ball when we come back. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
Randy Campbell.
I remember being in the locker room. You know, it's pretty famous. Coach Dye, it was, you know, totally silent in there. And the first thing I can remember Coach Dye saying is, listen to our people. And somebody opened the door to the locker room to let the sound come in. And none of the Auburn fans had left the stadium. And in unison, they're chanting, it's great to be an Auburn Tiger here at Jordan-Hare. So there's, you know, lots of them, 60,000 or whatever. You heard that, and it was so inspiring to hear that they cared that much, that they believed that we were going to accomplish some great things, and they were there to be a part of it and help it happen. But because of that, even though, you know, we were an underdog going into the Alabama game, but we didn't feel like underdogs.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
Things we take for granted, ordinary opportunities for parents and their children, can be a foster child's extraordinary. You have the power to do something positive that will change the life of a young person right here in Alabama. Open your heart and open your home to a foster child today. For more information, visit www.dhr.alabama.gov or call 1-866-64-AL-KIDS. Brought to you by the Alabama Department of Human Resources, the Alabama Broadcasters Association, and this station.
Auburn ball, Cal on top 3-0. 4:09 to go in the first quarter play. Let's pause 10 seconds so stations like 100.5, Jocks 2 in Birmingham can identify themselves on the Auburn Sports Network. First down from its own 26 for Auburn. Fake pitch by Thorne. Gets around the right side. He's to the 30 and tripped up there. So he gets 5 yards on the play for Peyton Thorne. A fake pitch left. He rolled right and got 5 yards in the play.
I like the call, Andy, because he fake tossed to the left, trying to get Peyton Thorne more involved in the game, trying to get him into the rhythm here. I'd like to see us get some quick passes, some quick hitters, and pick up a first down.
Second and five for Auburn. The Tigers looking for their initial first down tonight. From the right hash, double wide receivers, wide side of the field, the Auburn boundary. Handoff, tailback. No, it's Thorne again around right side. He's got the first down. Thorne taken out of bounds at the 36-yard line.
Great call right there by Coach Montgomery. But look at the block by Fairweather. Everyone knows he's a tight end, a pass catcher, but this guy just showed great blocking skills right there to spring Thorne on the edge.
He got 6 yards, did Peyton Thorne, and that is Auburn's initial first down. First down from the 36. Thorne play action, looks to throw to the sideline. It's incomplete. All kinds of contact there. The pass intended for Javarius Johnson.
Yeah, definitely contact there by Kalen Moore on the defense right there, but that's a long throw to be curling across the field for Peyton Thorne. You got to put that ball a little bit more outside, or otherwise it can be a house call for six for the defense.
From the right hash to the left boundary. Second and 10 for Auburn at its own 36-yard line. 3:10 to go first quarter. Cal on top, 3-0. Brings Fairweather in motion. Again, Thorne cuts it up. Undercut out to the 38-yard line. Peyton Thorne has been the sole runner on this drive. Craig Woodson from Grand Prairie, Texas, with the stop. Here's second or third down and 8 after a 2-yard gain by Thorne.
It's important for Auburn to pick up this third down right here to change the field position.
Tigers a row of 2 on third down tonight. Fairweather sets up outside the left tackle. Play clock at 10 for Auburn as Thorne looks to the sideline. Play clock at 5. Play clock at 2. There's the snap. Thorne to throw with some time. Looks, he throws incomplete. Trying to get it on a comeback route to Jair Shorter, but he threw it wide. It would have been enough for the Auburn first down.
Yeah, he tried to come back to the second receiver there, Jair Shorter. He wanted Jay Fair over the middle. Great job by Bears defense, where he was putting a linebacker in front of Jay Fair, the guy that he wanted. He tried to come back, but just couldn't complete the play right there. But hopefully we can get a good punt here, give Chapman a little bit more room to punt the ball out of.
Jeremiah Hunter drops back at the Cal 15 to take this punt from Oscar Chapman. High snap. Chapman gets it away, and it's a dandy. It's a boomer. And a fair catch back at the 12, and a flag in the Auburn backfield.
I think we're going to get running into the kicker. It's going to be the 5-yard penalty.
Yeah. The ball was downed at the Cal 13 after a 49-yard punt from Chapman. Do you just keep it there, or do you give him another shot to pin him even deeper?
Man, that's a great punt right there by Chapman. You have to think about this one a little longer, because the best you can do is just get him inside the 5-yard line, but you're taking a risk by letting that ball bounce into the end zone. You may just take the yardage here and just play defense.
It will be running into the kicker, not roughing the kicker.
Running into the kicker, receiving team. 5-yard penalty. The penalty is declined. It'll be first down, Cal.
And Cal with a 3-0 lead and 2:12 to go in the first quarter will have a big field to go now. First and 10 for Cal at its own 13-yard line when play resumes. Stay tuned, Auburn football continues in a moment.
The sweet smell of victory and grilled burgers still hang in the air. Your tailgate was a big win thanks to your Ford F-150 truck. With available Pro Power onboard, you used your F-150 as a mobile generator. That kept the celebration going long after the final whistle. See your local Ford dealer for great offers on a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
You've created a comfortable home office. Now let Carrier provide the cash bonus. For a limited time, you can claim up to $1,550 in cool cash rebates on a qualified Carrier home comfort system. There's never been a better time to upgrade to year-round premium comfort and energy savings.
Carrier, a proud partner of Auburn Athletics and special needs assistance stations for you. Turn to the experts with Carrier.
Listening to Auburn football. Back to more of the Tigers and Bears.
3-0 Cal leads it. 2:12 to go first quarter. Cal ball at its own 13. When play resumes, we'll send it down for a Cook's Pest Control sideline report. Here's Will Herring.
Yeah, guys, on one of those last plays, Jeremiah Irby, number 6, cornerback for the defense. Super aggressive on the comeback route. Look for Coach Freeze in this offense to try to hit him with a double move later on, maybe stretch the ball on a vertical route downfield. This kid is talented, but he's super aggressive. And it cost him last week against North Texas. And don't be surprised if we don't go deep with some sort of double move or just a go route here in the next drive or two.
All right, well, we'll file that one away. First and 10 for Cal at its own 13-yard line. Ball at the left hash mark. Finley, the quarterback. Ott is the tailback. He flanks the quarterback to his left. Finley out of the shotgun, hands the ball to Ott, and Ott puts his head down and gets out to the 16-yard line. A gain of 3 on the play as we approach the 2-minute mark of the first quarter. Cal on top, 3-0. Wesley Steiner on the stop for Auburn, plugging the goal, plugging the gap in the middle.
See number 87 out there for California offense. They call him Baby Gronk.
Second and 7. From the 16 for Cal. Tight end comes in motion. Ott with the carry. And Ott puts his head down out to the 19-yard line.
Great job of Eugene Asante getting in there on that tackle right there. Great job of filling in that hole and filling that gap.
Defenders on the field for Auburn, including Jalen McLeod. Good to see Jalen out there for the Tigers. Lines up at left defensive end. Here is 3rd and 3. From the 20 for Cal. Finley from the gun, wants the throw. Now throws it back, and Ott is taken down, and it's an incomplete pass. They were trying to set up Ott, and Eugene Asante snipped that one out.
The ruling on the field is an incomplete pass.
Eugene Asante having a big game right now, Andy. He read that out very, very well right there. Great job by Eugene of sticking to his assignment. We talked about that pregame. This is an offense that loves to be explosive. Stay true to your assignment.
6 tackles, 1.5 for loss, and a half sack last week for Asante, and he has picked up where he left off last week. 3-and-out for Tracker for the Auburn defense. 3-and-out Tracker driven by Truckworks, official commercial drug dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Keontae Scott at the Auburn 40, taking this punt from Lachlan Wilson. Good punt. Sends Keontae back to the 35-yard line, and he is taken down in the play. Really good punt by Wilson. Didn't give Keontae Scott much of an opportunity to return it. And good coverage by Cal. 1st and 10 for Auburn at its own 35-yard line after a 47-yard boomer from Lachlan Wilson out of Eaglemont, Australia. A couple of Aussie punters in this game tonight.
Yeah, you definitely got 2 guys that can flip field position in a hurry. People don't realize how important that punting game is. Right there, that was a great punt. Great job by Keontae after slipping down, getting back up to field that ball as well.
1st and 10 for Auburn. Ball is actually marked at the 33. Thorne, the quarterback. Jarquez Hunter in the backfield. So far, Jarquez on the night. 4 carries, 10 yards. A floater out to Hunter out of the backfield, eludes the first man, gets across the 35, and he's taken down at the 37.
I like the play call, Andy. Get these guys out on the edge, get 4 yards, make it 2nd and 6.
Jarquez made the first man miss, Got positive yardage for Auburn for 4 yards. Second and six for the Tigers. The nose of the football at the 37-yard line from the right hash. Bunch set for Auburn right now. Thorne out of the gun. Play action. Throws to the near sideline. 40 and near the 45-yard line. Should be enough for a first down. Jabarius Johnson. He does have the first down out to the 44.
I like the call there. Throw a bubble screen out of two tight end set with a bunch, two receivers bunched to the left right there. Great call by Coach Montgomery. Get the ball into our playmakers' hands.
7 yards and a first down, and that's the final play of the first quarter. After one in Berkeley, Cal 3, Auburn nothing. Register your child ages 5 to 12 for the Auburn Tigers kickoff kid contest from Berkshire Hathaway Home Services. Winners will see the kickoff from the sideline of Pat Dye Field, plus receive 4 game tickets, pregame VIP hospitality, a t-shirt, and video board recognition. Enter at auburnkickoffkid.com. That's auburnkickoffkid.com. After one at Cal, Golden Bears 3, Auburn nothing. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Come save with us. At Four Seasons Federal Credit Union, it's the time to save. The investment special is for a limited time only. Invest now and get a 7-month CD rate at 5% APR. Membership eligibility required. Dividends paid monthly. There is a penalty for early withdrawals. This certificate is non-renewable. Rates are subject to change without notice. This offer may be canceled at any time. Accounts are federally insured by the National Credit Union Administration. APR, annual percentage rate. APY, annual percentage yield. Effective July 1st, 2023.
Auburn made here. At Jewelry by Design, we are honored to design and hand make officially licensed Auburn University jewelry. All designs are limited edition or one of a kind and made here in our store. Jewelry by Design, proudly making Auburn jewelry in Auburn. Come by to see all of our fabulous designs or let us make you one. Follow us at jbdauburn.com. War Eagle from Jewelry by Design, located at 590 North Dean Road in Auburn.
More on your balances with the Max Elevate Money Market. Enjoy the competitive rate benefits of certificate accounts with no fixed terms and more flexibility. Earn more on your balances and access them anytime. You expect more and Max delivers. See our amazing rates at mymax.com/elevate. Max, smart money made simple. Federally insured by NCUA. Certain restrictions apply.
Life isn't made for joint or orthopedic pain. It's made for living, for family, for your favorite hobbies, for sports, for morning walks and afternoon playing in the park. If you suffer from joint or orthopedic pain, turn to the experts at the Orthopedic Clinic. Our board-certified surgeons provide cutting-edge surgical procedures and high-quality, innovative services all close to home. Don't let joint or orthopedic pain keep you from doing all the things you love. Visit theorthoclinic.com and schedule an appointment today.
Auburn overcame a disastrous start, trail 3-0 as we go to the second quarter. Some good defensive play helped the Tigers keep it to that margin. This game recap sponsored by Wind Creek Casino and Hotel with 3 Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka. You can escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and Hotel and at WindCreekCasino.com. Well, the Tigers gave up an early field goal after a fumble deep in their own territory. They got a penalty on the ensuing kickoff, had to start inside the 5 and couldn't get out of the hole. But Cal missed a field goal from 42 yards. From that point on, Auburn able to dominate and move the ball. And yardage about even now, but Cal leads at 3-0. Auburn with a first down near midfield to start the second quarter. Here's Andy Burchard.
All right, Paul, thank you. Robbie Ashford, the quarterback, to start the second quarter for Auburn. First and 10 from the Tiger 44, ball at the left hash. Battee and Hunter flank Ashford in the Auburn backfield. The snap, the handoff, near side. Jarquez Hunter gets to the 49, they'll give him midfield. It's a gain of 6 on the play for Jarquez Hunter. His deepest carry, was that Battee on the carry, and he gets to midfield. Yep. And they stay in, both Battee and Jarquez.
Brian Battee showing a little bit of that explosiveness right there, getting outside on the edge, making a great cut.
Petit goes in motion out of the backfield. The ball is flipped there from Ashford to Petit. Petit spun down and taken down, and he may lose a yard on the play. Al-Dakcha give him to the 50, and that's it. Craig Woodson had four tackles last week against North Texas, came up to make the stop, and here's a third down for Auburn. It's the deepest penetration for the Auburn offense tonight to midfield.
That's third and five here. We got to find a way to convert and get a first down.
And Thorne back in at quarterback for Auburn. Third and four for Auburn. Ball at the left hash. Thorne out of the gun. Jarquez Hunter now to his left. Play clock at seven. Snap to Thorne. A late snap, and it's going to be a flag on Auburn.
Yeah, it looked like a center hit that one.
Offense, number 72. Five-yard penalty, third down.
Miller moved, but I don't think that, excuse me, Isaiah Miller moved. I'm not sure that Avery Jones snapped it in time.
Yeah, I think that one's on Avery Jones. I think Thorne wanted the ball. He made the clap. Snap didn't get off on time. Now Robbie Ashford checks into the game.
That's third and nine now for Auburn. With Petit and Hunter in the backfield with Robbie Ashford. Third and nine, nose of the football, just shy of the Auburn 45. Ashford sends Jarquez out of the backfield. He looks and he flips the ball to Petit, and it's knocked out of his hands. It's an incomplete pass. Miles Jernigan, the outside linebacker, came up to knock the ball away from Brian Petit, and Auburn's drive stalls, and the Tigers will punt it away.
Yeah, that penalty hurt, Andy. It's like a third and five, made it a third and nine right there. Third and long situations on the road is not a good idea anytime. But right there, what a great play by their defense right there. Reading that screen play, coming backside, forcing the punt here.
Chapman will try to pin Jeremiah Hunter deep. Hunter stands at his own nine. The snap to Oscar, gets it away. End over end, fair catch call by Hunter at the 12-yard line. Good hang time by Oscar Chapman. A 38-yard punt. First and 10 for Cal. When we return, ball at the 12-yard line. 13:10 to go in the first half. Cal leads Auburn 3-0, and Auburn football continues in a moment.
Things we take for granted, ordinary opportunities for parents and their children, can be a foster child's extraordinary. You have the power to do something positive that will change the life of a young person right here in Alabama. Open your heart and open your home to a foster child today. For more information, visit www.dhr.alabama.gov or call 1-866-4AL-KIDS. Brought to you by the Alabama Department of Human Resources, the Alabama Broadcasters Association, and this station.
When you live in SEC country, you feel it everywhere you go. The traditions and rivalries surround you. As much as you celebrate the game, Regions celebrates your financial wins even more. And like SEC fans, we'll never quit. Because in an SEC world, we're the SEC Bank. Regions, official bank of the SEC, member FDIC.
Yellowwood knows that a five-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories. Like roasting marshmallows on a cool fall night. That's it. Turn it nice and slow. Get it toasted all... Oh, no, it's on fire. Oh, you want it on fire. Okay, that's a choice, I guess. Crunchy. For five-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
Auburn fans, this is Coach Hugh Freeze asking for your help. On to Victory has been a crucial supporter of Auburn student athletes. It's important to keep that good work going, so please join On to Victory today, War Eagle.
First and 10 for Cal at its own 17 when play resumes. 13:10 to go in the second quarter. The Bears, after a fumble on Auburn's opening drive, a 39-yard field goal from Michael Luckhurst. But Luckhurst has missed. And Cal's offense really hasn't moved the ball much since
Yeah, it's been a great job by our defense. I think that first quarter, that was a win for Auburn based off the field position that they gave up to Cal right there to only hold him to 3 points.
Isaiah Afonso checks in at the tailback spot, replacing Jaden Ott for Cal. A week ago, 10 carries, 54 yards, and 3 touchdowns at North Texas. And he will get the carry. He bounces to the outside. Good pursuit by Auburn. Ball is loose. Ball is loose. It's picked up by the Tigers at the 16-yard line. The ball was stripped at the 20, and Auburn recovers.
I think you're right, Andy. I think Auburn's got that ball right there.
The ruling on the field is a
Eugene
fumble
Asante.
Covered by the defense. First down, Auburn.
That's Kaufman stripped it, or excuse me, Asante stripped it. Kaufman recovered it.
That's what we need by our defense right there, to give a sudden change back to our offense, to create some short points right here. Hopefully we can get this thing in the end zone and change the attitude of this offense.
Looking at the replay, it looks like the ball's coming out before he's down, stripped out of there by Eugene Asante. And then Donovan Kaufman recovered it. Excuse me, Kaufman stripped it and recovered it. All right. And Ashford checks in at tailback. So does Damari Alston for the Tigers. First and 10, Auburn.
Is a fumble recovered by the defense. The previous play is under video review.
Auburn was trying to get the line of scrimmage and get the playoff as quick as it could. The one video replay tonight went the way of Cal. And replay reviews are brought to you by Auburn's Houston Clinic. Don't let a sport injury bench you this season. Go to Houston for your fracture, sprain, or strain. Because orthopedics is all they do. Go straight to the specialist. Go to Auburn's Houston Clinic.
We're looking at the replay as well. The ball is out before he goes down, unless they say that his elbow was down.
I think of his right knee right there is what they're going to be looking at to see if that ball was stripped, if his right knee was down or still on the ground when that ball was coming out.
Kaufman is the one that stripped it away for Auburn. I think the ball's out. Of course, I'm looking from the orange and blue side here of things. It was called a fumble, so it's got to be clear evidence that it was not, that he was down before the ball came out.
Donovan Kaufman is a guy that forces turnovers. Last week you saw him force a turnover against UMass that ended up in a Jalen Simpson's interception that went back to the house last week. Here he's involved right here, stripping his football away from Cal Bears running back.
Oh, I don't know.
It's going to be close here.
Yep.
Afonso rushed for 3 touchdowns last week against North Texas. Just saw his first action of the night.
Jalen McLeod is the one that was running down Afonso from behind and allowed Kaufman to reach in and strip the ball.
Yeah, Jalen McLeod, the transfer from App State, known as a pass rusher, but this guy's hustle, we need him on defense to create these type of plays.
They're taking a while, aren't they? Daniel Gautreaux looking into a monitor at the Auburn 16-yard line near the Auburn sideline. And the review is done, and here is the call.
After video review, the ruling on the field stands. Yes. First down.
Well, there's the first big break by the Auburn defense.
It has not been easy for these refs on these two calls that they have to go to the sideline and review, one by Thorne and right there by Funze. But great job by the defense to create a short field for offense. Andy, we need a touchdown here.
So Alston stays in at tailback. And Robbie Ashford, the quarterback, from the right hash mark. First and 10 for Auburn at the Cal 17. Fairweather is the tight end, sets up outside the right. Well, actually, double tight ends on the right side. The snap. Ashford, left side, Alston, inside the 15. Alston spun, he got to the 11.
Yes, Alston running behind that big offensive line on the left, Dylan Wade and Gunnar Britton right there.
6 yards for Alston. Second down and a short 4 for Auburn from the left hash. Auburn in the Chick-fil-A red zone. The snap, Ashford around right side. Tries to get to the outside and he's taken down after a loss on the play. Number 2 coming up, Craig Woodson. Fought off a block and made the stop. A fine play by Woodson.
Yeah, Craig Woodson looked like he read that one right there. Andy, we got some change on the offensive line here. Jeremiah Wright is in at the right guard, and Cam Stutz is in at the left guard.
A loss of two, and Thorne back in the game for Auburn at tailback. So is, a quarterback, and so is Jarquez Hunter at tailback. Third and a six for Auburn. The Tigers 0 of 4 on third down tonight. Double wide receivers right and left. Ball at the right hash mark. Thorne from the gun. Cowd rushes four. Thorne throws across the middle. Jay Fair, he's to the 10, he's to the 5, he's in! Touchdown, Auburn! Jay Fair on the crossing route. 13 yards and a score, and Auburn takes the lead.
Man, Peyton had two guys open right there. Jarquez ran a wheel route. That was his first progression. He didn't like it. He saw Jay Fair coming across on the crossing route. Great design right there by Coach Montgomery, Coach Freeze. Great job of getting that ball in the end zone. A sudden change.
Second touchdown of the year for Jay Fair. The Tigers take advantage of the fumble recovery by Donovan Kaufman and take the lead.
And that was done behind our backup offensive line there.
Alex McPherson for the extra point. Chapman holds. Quattabom snaps. Snap down. Kick on the way. It is good. He was 8 of 8 last week for Auburn at PATs. McPherson good tonight in his first. And with 11:50 to go in the second quarter of play, a crossing route by Jay Fair for the touchdown. And Auburn takes the lead 7-3 with 11:50 to go in the first quarter. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Live Sports Radio, bringing you all the action of game day with no delay. Every touchdown, interception, sideline report, and all the analysis from Andy Burcham, Jason Campbell, Ronnie Brown, and Will Herring. Yours at home and on the road. And they're good all through the spring. When football ends, you can still hear every broadcast of home men's and women's basketball, baseball, and softball, all with no delay. Live Sports Radio and Alpha Insurance, keeping you plugged into the Tigers at home and on the road.
Do you say War Eagle instead of hello? See tigers in the clouds? Never wear crimson and white together? If so, there's no better way to show your tiger pride than with the Auburn University Regents Visa debit card and prepaid Regents Now card. As passionate as you are about Auburn, Regents is even more passionate about celebrating your every financial win and helping you plan for the next one. To order your card, visit Regents.com/GoTigers. Regents, official bank of the SEC, member FDIC. Terms, conditions, and fees apply.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever?
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for... Aw, Jim!
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
We're still on the air.
Hello, this is Coach Hugh Freeze. They say Coke Zero Sugar is irresistibly tasty. Does that make it the best Coke ever? Find out for yourself. War Eagle.
When you see the SEC student athlete, it's easy to picture the swing, the stance, the form. But look closer, and you'll see the heart, the brain, the clutch lab partner, the avid two-stepper, the pride of a hometown, and a little brother's hero. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Auburn leads 7-3 with 11:50 to go in the second quarter. The Sun-South John Deere drive summary. 17 yards, 3 plays, a minute 11. Peyton Thorne to Jay Fair for 13 yards. All set up by the Kaufman fumble recovery. Sun-South John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. Boy, just a well-executed play for Auburn on third down.
Yeah, one you have to have right there. A field goal would have just even the game, but that right there puts a dagger in Cal's offense.
Lumagia Hearns deep to take this kickoff, and he calls for a fair catch in the end zone off the foot of Alex McPherson. So Auburn gets a fumble recovery deep in Cal territory. The Tigers do something Cal did not early, and that has turned it into a touchdown.
Yeah, and that's the difference, Andy. They was able to get a field goal. Our defense held them to a field goal, but our offense was able to put up seven. That's the difference in sudden change. You didn't want to give up a touchdown. Great job by Auburn's offense right there to put seven on the board. The offensive line gave Peyton time right there to find his second progression, hit Jay Fair on the crossing route.
First and 10 from the 25 for Cal. Finley, the quarterback, to Ott. Ott shows some patience, but Auburn is there. He got 2 yards, and that is all. Trying to go right up the middle. There are a host of Auburn jerseys there. Justin Rogers led the charge. So did Donovan Kaufman for the Tigers.
Again,
second and 8.
Again, Justin Rogers transferred from Kentucky, but also getting involved there, that star player on defense we called a nickel, Donovan Kaufman.
Ott now sets up in a slot to the right, trips to the wide side of the field. Finley alone in the backfield out of the shotgun. Auburn brings the blitz, the throw to the sideline, short of the 30-yard line and down on the play. Number 14, Monroe Young, immediately wrapped up by Donovan Kaufman. And it will bring up third down and 5. It's a gain of 4 on the play.
Great closing speed right there by Kaufman. He's just only allowed a catch. No yak after the catch.
All right, third and 5. Would they go wide side and let Ott try to get to the boundary? From the left hash. Trips to the wide side of the field for Cal. A single receiver to the Auburn boundary. Ott to the right side of Ben Finley on third and 5. Auburn rushes 6. Finley throws. It is caught at the 36-yard line and a first down to Jeremiah Hunter.
Yeah, Auburn brought the blitz up the middle, but Jeremiah Hunter, Finley sat in the pocket and let him work DJ James down on the bottom. Just enough for the sticks.
A gain of 6 on the play. First and 10 from the Cal 36. The throw to the sideline. Again, Hunter, nothing doing this time. Hunter gets maybe a yard or maybe just back to the line of scrimmage. They give him 1 on the play. Eugene Asante, DJ James for the Tigers.
Jalen McLeod right there showing his speed there, Andy. Coming inside out again to get involved on an outside screen pass.
A gain of about 0.5 yards, second down for the Bears from the left hash. Double wide receivers right and left. Ott now in motion out of the backfield. Finley looks that way, he throws it, it's incomplete. Tried to throw to the Auburn boundary. Eugene Asante with coverage on Monroe Young. It's third down and 10.
Yeah, it's good design right there by Coach Robert. He's going to bring a nickel blitz. They motioned out the backfield, and then that bumped our nickel outside, and then they brought Larry Nitzen off the edge right there to create pressure and force a bad throw.
Third and 10. Make that third and 9 for the Bears. 2 of 6 on third down tonight. From the Cal 36, tight end in motion. Finley from the gun. Play action. Finley steps and he throws up the sideline. The receiver, Young, broke off his route. It's incomplete and Auburn's defense holds.
Great coverage by Keontae Scott there, but the pressure off that left side up top right there, creating that throw to have to come out. Finley have to deliver that ball a lot earlier than he wants.
And Lachlan Wilson, who has a 47-yarder tonight, will punt it away for Cal. Keontae Scott backs up to the Auburn 26-yard line. The snap and the kick is away. It's another good one. Asante at the 28. Forward 35 and tripped up as he gets close to the 40-yard line. Nice return by Keontae Scott. He may have been one tackle away from a big gainer, but he gives Auburn good field position with 9:26 to go in the second quarter. 39-yard punt, 11-yard return by Keontae Scott.
Yeah, Keontae, a former from California, San Diego, so this is a home game for him. But that play started with Kyan Lee getting a great block at the initiation of Keontae Scott receiving that ball.
First and 10 for Auburn, football at the 39-yard line. Thorne is the quarterback for the Tigers. Sends one wide receiver wide left, that's Jair Shorter. 2 to the short side of the field for the Tigers. Thorne drops to throw. Double pumps. Now out of the pocket. Gets some help. Flag is down. Auburn's going to be called for a hold as he throws it out of bounds. Good coverage by Cal, and this will be a hold on Dylan Wade, the Auburn left tackle.
Yeah, he wanted to hit Javaris Johnson
holding
down the seam.
Offense, number 52. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
That was the initial look, wasn't it?
Yeah, the initial look was to hit Javarius down the seam. He didn't like it, tried to come back. He might have had Fairweather down the field a little bit, but I think he was trying to get outside the edge, and Dylan Wade got caught with a hold.
And that backs it up to the 29-yard line. So first and 20 for the Tigers. Alston is the tailback for Auburn. Fairweather in motion. Handoff to Alston, turns it upfield. He's through the 35, 40, and out past the original line of scrimmage. He gets to the 42-yard line, and it brings up second down and 8. 13 yards on the gain for Damari Alston.
Nice run right there behind Cam Stutz and big, too tall Miller.
Second and 7 for Auburn. A quick throw to Alston, sideline, upfield. Looks like he has the Auburn first down. He goes out of bounds at midfield. It's a first down for the Tigers. He gets 8 yards on the play.
Nice play design right there. Running a rub out of the backfield. Damari Alston, great job by the outside receiver. Everyone noticed number 3. It was Shane Hooks last week as number 11 has changed his number.
Auburn substituted, so has to wait now to snap it. Ball at midfield. First and 10 for the Tigers from the right hash mark at midfield. Thorne out of the gun. Drops to throw. Steps up to the pocket. He's going to run it, and he gets inside Cal territory to the 48-yard line. A couple yards in the play for Peyton Thorne.
Yeah, Auburn trying to take some shots with the Bears defense and not let them get on top of them. They're doing a good job of getting depth and not letting our receivers pass by them.
David Reese, one of the many transfers for Cal with the stop, a transfer from Florida. Second and 8 for Auburn at the Cal 48. 8 minutes to go, first half. Auburn 7, Cal 3. From the right hash mark, Fairweather goes in motion. Handoff near side. That is Damari Alston. Head down across the 40. Alston knocked forward. He gets to the 35. Ball is loose. Ball is loose, but I think he was down.
Yeah, I think
he was ruled down at the 35-yard line.
Yeah, I think he was down as well, but I think they found something at right side of the offensive line behind too tall Miller and Cam Stutz this drive.
As the runner is down by rule, first down Auburn.
13-yard gain for Damari Alston.
Yeah, big gain right there. Early in the game, we tried to go to that right side. We couldn't find anything, but we're finding a lot here lately in the second quarter.
Jarquez Hunter checks in at tailback. First and 10 for Auburn at the Cal 35. Again, from the right hash mark, short side of the field to the Auburn boundary.
The ruling on the field is the runner is down by rule. The previous play is under video review.
It's out. Yeah.
And that one may go Cal's way.
Tough break right there for Auburn.
If that's the way it is. Replay reviews are presented by Auburn's Houston Clinic. Don't let a sports injury bench you this season. Go to Houston for your fracture, sprain, or strain. Because orthopedics is all they do. Go straight to the specialist. Go to Auburn's Houston Clinic. And that ball is coming out, I'm afraid, before he is down. Cal recovered it, by the way.
Yeah, in that situation, you want to try to go fast, but they get the review call from upstairs. There's nothing you can do about it as Auburn offense, but tough break right here if this ball goes against us.
And I'm afraid it may. The reviews we're getting that you perhaps are watching yourself shows that that ball is coming out as he is going down, which nullifies a terrific run.
Yeah.
And would give Auburn first down at the Cal 35.
Yeah, it seemed like Saunders.
After video review, the ruling on the field is overturned to a fumble. First down and 10. Cal at the 35-yard line.
It would have been first down for Auburn at the Cal 35, but Alston fumbled. Yeah. Auburn's second turnover of the night.
Andy, look, that ball hit off Saunders. It's almost he was going down. He caught the backside leg of the defender, Saunders, for Cal Bears.
It's Ethan Saunders, defensive tackle out of Inglewood, California. Sam Jackson, the fifth, is the quarterback for Cal. He's more of the runner. He was 3 of 4 for 75 yards last week before he injured his right shoulder early in the second quarter at North Texas. Brings a man in motion from the right hash. He looks and he throws that way to Monroe Young. Young to the 40 and taken out of bounds at the 41-yard line. 6 yards on the play for Cal.
Young, one of those fast receivers of Cal Bears, they rave about this guy's speed and explosiveness. Got him on the edge right there, making it a second and four.
Out of Las Cruces, New Mexico, with 4 catches, 63 yards last week. Second and four for Cal at its own 41. Jackson hands it up the middle. It's Ott. Ott, second effort, gets across the 45 and a first down for Cal to the 46.
Yeah, Ott running tough right there between the left guard and left tackle right there. Pick up that first down for Cal Bears.
First and 10 for the Bears at their own 46-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field. Jackson, the quarterback, out of the gun. Snap, play action. Jackson throws it up the sideline. It's caught. Auburn thought he pushed off. Didn't get the call. The catch by Jeremiah Hunter.
Yeah, see how that back ref could not see the extended arm by Hunter on DJ James right there to create that separation.
To the Auburn 32. Cal quickly back to the line of scrimmage. 6:07 in the first half. Auburn 7, Cal 3. Jackson with time. Now flushed out of the pocket. He's got some room to run. Jackson to the 30 and out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
Yeah, they say Jackson's a 4-3-4-4 guy. Like I said, former receiver for our quarterback Peyton Thorne at Napier Central High School.
He got 4 yards on the play, out of bounds. As the clock rolls down to the 5:43 mark, second down for Cal at the Auburn 28. Ball at the right hash. Jackson with Ott to his left. Jackson brings Hunter across in motion. Jackson hands the ball to Jaden Ott. 25, down the sideline. Jumps inside the 15-yard line. First down for Cal. Zion Puckett, perhaps, with a touchdown-saving tackle for Auburn.
Yeah, that was a great tackle by Zion, because that ball would have been in the end zone and went for that tackle. But at the same time, we're in a two-shell. Gain of 14 yards there.
First and 10 from the Auburn 14. The Bears trying to regain the lead. Jackson from the gun. Ball at the right hash mark. Double wide receivers to the wide side of the field. He hands the ball to Ott. Ott at the two. Head down, dives forward. Touchdown, Cal.
Yeah, they caught our defense in a two shell. It seems like anytime they see us in a two high shell, they decide they want to run the football. We may have to come out of that two shell here after this series, because we don't want to give up that much running yards against a six-man box.
Explain a two-shell, Jason.
Yeah, you got two safeties out of the box right there. Where they're looking at is too high or out of quarters, and that's a run look for our offense. You feel like you got numbers with your offensive line against our defensive front and linebacker. We got to find a way to maybe get our secondary back involved into our run defense and get seven people down in that box to stop this run game.
A fumble at the Cal 35, and the Bears turned it into a touchdown drive. Luckhurst for the extra point. Kick is on the way, and it is good. 4:47 to go in the second quarter. Cal back on top. CBNS Bank has been family, community, and financially strong since they began in 1906. Visit cbsbank.com, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Cal 10, Auburn 7. 4:47 to go in the second quarter. Auburn football continues in a moment.
What widens the eyes, tightens the stomach, and flutters the heart. Adrenaline. Feel it for yourself in the Toyota RAV4, Camry, Corolla, and Tacoma. Get 2.9% APR for 36 months on our new 2023 Toyota RAV4. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through October 3rd, 2023. Zero down for well-qualified buyers with approved credit and financing through Southeast Toyota Finance. 29.04 monthly payment for $1,000 finance. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
In football, it's important to call the right play. In life, it can be even more important to make the right call, especially regarding termite protection. To protect my home, I called Cook's Pest Control and got the Centricon system. You don't have to live with termites. For a free quote, make the right call. Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon system.
The Houston Clinic would like to welcome Dr. Brad Young, the newest addition to our team of experienced medical professionals at Auburn's Houston Clinic. Specializing in joint replacements, sports medicine, and arthroscopic surgery, Dr. Young has treated athletes and worked with sports teams from middle and high school to college and professional teams. Call now to schedule your evaluation. Houston Clinic. Research, education, treatment. Houston.com.
Next week, Auburn hosts Sanford for homecoming on the Plains. Coverage begins next Saturday at 3 Central. Now back to more of Auburn and Cal.
4:47 to go in the second quarter. 10-7 Cal on top. Downstairs, Cook's Pest Control sideline report. Here is Will Herring.
Yeah, guys, when you get in the red zone, the vertical threat goes away. And so you see these safeties start to flat foot everything. And as Jason mentioned, they were showing a two shell, and it's something to keep an eye on. This quarterback has got to be accounted for as long as they have the athletic quarterback. Sometimes these safeties, though, will flat foot at 8 yards rather than in the open field. They're starting at 10 or 12, and they're rolling down to 7 or 8. So definitely something to keep an eye on, because this quarterback's an athlete, and we've got to account for him.
Luckhurst to kick it away. Batee at the goal line. Brings it up the middle of the field. Brian Batee puts his head down and gets out to the 24-yard line. 65-yard drive for Cal in 6 plays. Jaden Ott, 14 yards for the touchdown after the fumble at the Cal 35-yard line. Boy, Auburn was moving the football, had a 10-3 lead. How things can change as quick as possible.
Yeah, what a change of events. Unfortunately for Auburn, you're about to go up 14-3, and now you find yourself down 10-7.
Jarquez Hunter, the tailback. Peyton Thorne, the quarterback. Handoff goes to Jarquez, tries to get around left side, and he gets a yard, and that's all.
Yeah, trying to go back behind Dylan Wade and Gunnar Britton on that left side of the ball on our offensive line.
Jarquez with a yard gain on the play, 2nd and 9 from the Auburn 26. Double wide receivers right and left for the Tigers. Snap, Thorne, 2 throw across the middle. It's complete out to the 32-yard line. Complete, it'll be a couple yards shy of the first down. Rivaldo Fairweather with his first Auburn reception.
Yeah, they ran him onto what you call a Hank route, where you get a hook 5 yards over the ball.
Quick, back to the line of scrimmage, 3rd and 2 for Auburn. Play action, throw up the sideline, and it's incomplete. Intended at midfield on the play for Omari Kelly. Had single coverage down the Cal sideline.
Yeah, they saw single coverage there, trying to hit Omari Kelly on their defensive back right there. Not a lot of room, not a lot of cushion, not a high percentage play on a 3rd and short like that.
And Chapman out to punt it away as Auburn goes 3 and out. With 2:40, make that 3:49 to go in the second quarter. Jeremiah Hunter to take this punt. He's at the Cal 19. Another good punt by Chapman. And Hunter calls for a fair catch at the 19-yard line. 49-yard punt by Oscar Chapman. Cal ball when we come back. 3:41 to go in the second quarter. Cal on top 10-7. 1st and 10 for the Bears at their own 19 when we return. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Eagle 102.3 is your East Alabama and Midwest Georgia's country music leader, playing the top hits from the hottest artists. Download our Eagle 102.3 app so you can listen to us whenever and wherever. Listen to your favorite country artists, stay up to date on your favorite college football team,
War Eagle,
and catch our local high school football broadcasts, all from our app. Available on Apple and the Google Play Store. For more information, visit our website, eagle1023.com, or find our link tree on Instagram at WELR Eagle.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
When you live in SEC country, you feel it everywhere you go. The traditions and rivalries surround you. As much as you celebrate the game, Regions celebrates your financial wins even more. And like SEC fans, we'll never quit. Because in an SEC world, we're the SEC Bank. Regions, official bank of the SEC, member FDIC.
What widens the eyes, tightens the stomach, and flutters the heart. Adrenaline. Feel it for yourself in the Toyota RAV4, Camry, Corolla, and Tacoma. Lease a new 2023 Toyota RAV4 LE for $319 a month for 36 months. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through October 3rd, 2023. Well qualified lessees with approved credit through Southeast Toyota Finance. 3618 due at signing. No security deposit with select equipment. $350 disposition fee. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fee. See dealer for details.
Three minutes and 41 seconds to go in the second quarter. Cal on top of Auburn 10-7. Cal ball when play resumes at the 19-yard line. Cal relied on the running on that last drive from Sam Jackson, the fifth, and Jaden Ott.
Yeah, I'll see if we still stay in that two shell, Andy. That's what they caught us in last series, and they ran the ball very well. But this is a situation where we want to try to get them off the field. There's 3 minutes and 41 seconds left in the first half. We need this chance to get the ball back.
From the right hash mark, Jackson the quarterback, Ott is the tailback, with Young in motion. Handoff goes to Jaden Ott. He stood up behind the line of scrimmage, barely got back to the line of scrimmage before he went down. Larry Nixon the third, transfer from North Texas, with the stop for Auburn.
Yeah, Larry Nixon getting on that tackle, but also Keontae Scott from that star position on defense. You see they're getting him back involved in the run defense right there.
Second down, they'll give him a yard. Second and nine. Jackson from the gun. Play action, drops to throw. Looks to the sideline, he throws. The pass is complete and immediately taken down. Keontae Scott took down Jeremiah Hunter after a two-yard gain.
Yeah, Jackson, like he's just playing backyard football. There's no, in his drop, there's no just three steps, four steps. He's just floating back there and trying to find a way to make something happen. Great job by Keontae Scott flying inside on that defense.
Third and seven for Cal. The Bears are 2 of 7 on third down tonight. Ball at the left hash. Double wide receivers right and left. Jackson drops to throw, sets, and he throws to the sideline. The pass is complete to Brian Hightower for a first down. Hightower out to the 33-yard line.
That was a strong throw right there by Jackson. I mean, yeah, Jackson threw that ball from the left mark all the way across the field on a little like a quick out route.
First and 10 for the Bears at their own 33. Handoff, Ott up the middle. Stood up at the line of scrimmage. He got a yard and that's all.
Yeah, big Jason Jones up in there on that tackle right there. They're not moving that big mountain of a man.
He had just checked into the ball game for the Tigers in the middle. And he plugged the gap. They gave him a yard, second and nine. Trips to the wide side of the field. That's the Auburn boundary. Second down and nine for Jackson and Cal. Play action, he rolls to the Auburn sideline. He throws there and it's incomplete. Intended for Monroe Young, defended by Jalen Simpson.
Yeah, I thought they were gonna try to run a sprint pass, but then he saw Keontae Scott coming in Jackson's face. He had tried to deliver the ball outside. Ball got away from him out of bounds. Great design right there by Coach Roberts.
Third and nine for Cal. Clock stopped with a minute 37 to go in the second quarter. Cal on top of Auburn, 10-7.
Auburn with all three timeouts need to stop right here big time.
Jackson out of the gun. Auburn rushes four. Jackson throws it. And incomplete. No flags. There was some contact. Brian Hightower, the intended receiver, Kyan Lee, with good defending for Auburn in front of the Cal bench.
Tell you what, that Kyan Lee is a playmaker. That defense playing that corner position for Nehemiah Pritchard tonight. They talked about him in camp early on. This kid is beyond his years. Great stop for the Auburn defense. Minute 33 with three timeouts. Hope to get a score.
Lachlan Wilson will punt it away. Keontae Scott with the back of his heels at the Auburn 25-yard line. Wilson rolls to his right and gets it away. End over end. Keontae Scott with a fair catch at the 24-yard line. Auburn with a minute 25 to go in the first half, first and 10. Let's pause 10 seconds so stations like WALW in Moulton can identify themselves on the Auburn Sports Network.
Great decision right there by Keontae to catch that.
You like the decision by Keontae to get that fair catch, not let it go deep.
All right, you don't want to, with a minute and 30, with a minute 25, with three timeouts, you want to give your offense at least an opportunity to get in field goal range.
First and 10 for Auburn at its own 24. Play action, roll out by Peyton Thorne. He throws it ahead to Fairweather, the tight end, gets across the 35-yard line, taken down at the 36, and there's a flag down in the Auburn backfield. This is coming back, I'm afraid.
Yeah, not sure what this is going to be. Only thing I can think of is illegal lineman downfield.
Ineligible player downfield. Offense, number 62. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Got Cam Stutz for releasing early.
Yeah, you got to know it's offensive lineman. We're in those bootlegs. You can't be on 2 to 3 yards down the field. You just got to decide to stay in there and let your quarterback and receivers just kind of make a play.
1:18 to go in the first half. Auburn backed up to its own 19-yard line.
I may see a screen play here, Andy.
Auburn with trips to the wide side of the field, the Auburn boundary. Thorne looks to throw. With time, throws it. It's in and out of the hands, and it is intercepted. Over the head of Shane Hooks and Nohai Williams with the interception. Yeah, oh, my.
Yeah, he had Shane right there on the curl route. Exactly what you wanted. Ball just kind of got away from him. A little bit too high for Shane, who's a 6'5 receiver. So that ball got away from Peyton, a little bit too high for him. Ball tipped in the air. Ball doesn't find the ground with tipped balls.
Williams got his first start last week. It's his first Cal interception this week and gives Cal great field position at its own 26-yard line. And remember, Cal will get the ball coming out in the third quarter. Ball at the 34-yard line.
This is a must for Auburn's defense to hold them to three here or force a long field goal. They've missed the field goal here early in the first quarter. See if we can hold them and make them miss another one.
Just inside the left hash, Jackson is the quarterback. The tailback is Jaden Ott, flanks him to the right. From the gun, Jackson. Play action, looking, now flushed. Jackson tries to get to the outside, pressured. He throws it away. Good coverage by Auburn and good pursuit on Sam Jackson, the fifth.
Yeah, great coverage by Auburn's defense right there. Not to give up the explosive play. Anytime there's a sudden turnover, always look for a next explosive play for the offense to take a shot.
Looked like Jalen Simpson perhaps was a spy that time on Jackson.
Yeah, Jalen Simpson came flying from depth right there to make sure that Jackson couldn't run and pick up 5 or 10 with his legs.
Second and 10 from the Auburn 34 for Cal. 54 seconds to go in the second quarter. Cal on top, 10-7. Jackson turns, hands the ball. Ott taken down at the line of scrimmage. Good pursuit off the edge from Marcus Harris to take down Jaden Ott.
Got a timeout here, Andy, by Cal
timeout.
Bears.
Cal, it is their first. It will be 30 seconds.
No one gets you closer to the game than Sirius XM SEC Radio. Hear live games, news, analysis, and more. Visit SiriusXM.com and start listening. Jaden Ott, who ran for 188 yards last week, 14 carries for 63 yards here tonight.
Yeah, our defense doing a pretty good job on him. He got away on us one time down in their red zone. We were caught in a too high shell, and he was able to break through and score. But for the most part, our defense has contained him pretty well.
Total yards tonight, Cal 129 yards on offense, Auburn 99. Penalties on the last drive, a penalty on the last drive, and a fumble deep in the Cal territory on the previous drive have halted the last two Auburn drives.
Our defense has made sure they watch the quarterback draw here now. They can't get too loose playing coverage and forget about Jackson in the backfield.
Third and 10 from the Auburn 34. Jackson right up the middle, and Auburn sniffs it out. Again, it's Marcus Harris. He was the first one there to get Sam Jackson.
Yes, Harris forced the cut, and then Mosiah Kite right there with the tackle.
So no gain. This would be a field goal of about 50 yards. The longest field goal of Luckhurst's career is 39. It came earlier in this game. It looks like Cal will just let the clock run down.
They let it go down about 3 seconds. They're going to take a timeout.
And timeout called with two. You missed it by a second, Smooth.
Yeah, they always tell us to do it with 3 seconds to make sure that the ref is on it. But what a great stop by Auburn's defense
sure
right there. That was big time. A turnover, not to force a long field goal here. I take our chances.
This would be a field goal of about 51 yards if Cal takes a look at it. Michael Luckhurst is the son of Mick Luckhurst, former kicker with the Falcons. He is in the Cal Athletic Hall of Fame as both a football player and a rugby player, his father.
Yeah, you got good genes, I can say that. But right here, Andy, what you want to see from a 50-yard field goal is he's going to have to take some of the air out of this ball just to get the distance. So expect our edge rusher, Jalen Simpson, may have a shot right here to try to get a hand on that ball, or big Jason Jones in the middle, number 99. He's blocked some field goals before. He's big tall guy in the middle.
Simpson will come off the right edge. This will be just inside a 52-yard field goal for Luckhurst. And timeout by Auburn. Hugh Freeze will give Luckhurst an opportunity to think about it. One thing you can no longer do is call back-to-back timeouts. So this would be the only timeout he could call to try and ice the kicker. One of the new rules this year in college football.
Only thing I don't like is under 2 minutes, you should be able to call back-to-back timeouts. You know, the walk into halftime with timeouts in your pocket does you no good. I like the fact that being able to ice the kicker. If I got two timeouts, why can't I call two timeouts back-to-back?
Because it's the new rule.
Gosh. It's new rules every year. Football had been the same for the last 20 years.
Well, this is not a rule. Or this is not a year for massive rules. That's perhaps coming next year. All right, 52-yard field goal by Luckhurst. Ball in the middle of the field. The snapper is David Byrd. The punter, Lachlan Wilson, will hold. Snap is down. The kick is on the way. The kick is good. And a flag is thrown. And this may finally get the hook on Jalen Simpson coming off the edge. It was a late flag that was thrown.
That's the same one they missed early in the game on the first 3 points that Cal got on the field goal. They hooked Jalen Simpson. This time they did it again. Late.
Kicking team number 44. 10-yard penalty. We will play one untimed down.
It's a shame for Luckhurst because he knocked it home from 52 yards and had room to spare.
Yeah, that was a boom kick by Luckhurst, but at the same time, that's the same exact thing that happened on the first field goal that didn't get called. This time it was called, it was late, but at least they called it.
So that 10-yard penalty will take Cal, we would think, out of field goal range. And Auburn will send, they're going to send the defense back on. Yep, because Jackson comes out for
he's
Cal.
He's still in there. They'll call a timeout here, but they're going to probably run a Hail Mary pass. What they're going to do is tell Jackson try to float back there as long as he possibly can and try to let his receivers get downfield.
Well, we've seen he's got the arm to get it to the end zone, no question. This will be an untimed play. It will be the final play of the first half, and a timeout is called.
Yeah, we're going to go prevent defense here.
Zion Puckett deep, Jalen Simpson deep, Keontae Scott deep for Auburn.
I've seen in the past, Andy, sometimes they take some of your tallest receivers like a Shane Hooks or, you know, a Camden Brown, and you usually put them at the goal line and say, hey, if that ball gets up there, you jump to the highest point and knock it down. Do not try to catch it. Just knock the ball down.
Zion Puckett and Jalen Simpson are back at the goal line.
The key here is knock the ball down. Don't worry about trying to pass your stats. Just get the ball on the ground.
Ball will be snapped just inside the Auburn 45-yard line. There's the snap to Jackson. He's flushed out of the pocket. He rolls to the Cal boundary. and he throws it on the run to the end zone. Jalen Simpson intercepts it. He brings it out to the 10, 15 to the 20. If he can get to the sideline, he's got a chance. Trying to get to the Auburn boundary, and he goes down at the 25. Jalen Simpson with his second interception of the season. Good coverage, good pursuit. That's the way the first half comes to a close.
Yeah, great job by Asante right there, forcing Jackson out of the pocket, having to make a throw and a run 50 yards into the end zone. Didn't give his receivers a chance to get over there. Great job by the Auburn defense not to sit back.
That's the second interception of the year for the Tigers. That means another $1,000 for Children's of Alabama. We'll send it downstairs, Will Herring, with Auburn head coach.
Many teams, much less a good California team. And we've had penalties, we've done things that we didn't do at all the first game, and it's just been really sloppy offensively. And I thought we had something going there, and turn it over, and then they go down and score. So we've got to get in and settle our guys down. Our defense is playing great. We got to get offense figured out.
Okay, good luck in the second half, Coach.
Well, Herring with Auburn head coach Hugh Freeze. That second interception of the year for the Tigers. That means another $1,000 for Children's of Alabama through the Picks for Kids program. Chick-fil-A donating $1,000 for each Tiger pick. That's two interceptions. $2,000 for Children's of Alabama. Eat More Chicken and War Eagle from Chick-fil-A. The score at the half, Cal 10, Auburn 7. Here's Paul Ellen with the Truckworks halftime report.
All right, thank you very much, Andy. An interesting first half. All the points coming after turnovers. You can bet both coaches have a lot to correct at halftime of this one, with Cal leading Auburn by a score of 10-7. Time to check the Yellowwood scoreboard. And the SEC finally has a victory over a Power 5 team. It did not come easy. It came, of all places, in Starkville, Mississippi, where Mississippi State beat Arizona in overtime 31-24. Elsewhere, let's check the scoreboard. Most games are either very late or final as far as the top 25 in the SEC are concerned. Fourth-ranked Florida State 66-13 over Southern Miss. That is in Tallahassee, and there's 3:05 left in that one. 16th-ranked Oregon State pounding UC Davis 55-7. 6th-ranked Southern Cal running away from Stanford in the Coliseum 42-3. It was number 1 Georgia over Ball State 45-3. Number 5 Ohio State beat Youngstown State 35-7. 7th-ranked Penn State 63-7 winner over Delaware. Number 10 Notre Dame went on the road and beat NC State in Raleigh 45-24. 12th-ranked Utah also on the road. They struggled in Waco but hung on to beat Baylor 20-13. 15th-ranked Kansas State beat Troy 42-13. Number 22, Colorado pulled away late from Nebraska 36-14, really dominated throughout. Number 25, Clemson beat Charleston Southern 66-17. And number 2, Michigan, a 35-7 winner over UNLV. Ole Miss dominated the second half and held on to beat Tulane, number 24 Tulane, 37-20. 23rd-ranked Texas A&M, the only top 25 team to lose today. Miami beat them in Miami 48-33. Number 8, Washington over Tulsa 43-10. 9th-ranked Tennessee, 30-13 winner over Austin Peay. 17th-ranked North Carolina hung on in double overtime to beat Appalachian State 40-34. 18th-ranked Oklahoma, 28-11 winner over SMU. Number 21, Duke, won their second game in 6 days. They beat Lafayette 42-7. 11th-ranked Texas went to Tuscaloosa, beat number 3 Alabama 34-24. 13th-ranked Oregon beat Texas Tech in Lubbock 38-30. 14th-ranked LSU, an easy winner, 72-10 over Grambling. 19th-ranked Wisconsin upset on the road. Washington State went to 2-0, beating Wisconsin 31-22. And 16th-ranked Oregon State, a 55-7 winner over UC Davis. Hey, visit truckworks.com. That's what, truckworks with an X.com, for more information on the company or to learn more about career opportunities with Truckworks. It is 10-7. California leading Auburn. We're at halftime. Stay with us. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Download the new and improved Auburn Game Day app. It's fully customizable to your interests with the new My Auburn tab.
Plus, buy tickets, skip concession lines, be a part of game day giveaways, shop the latest Auburn gear, and get live in-game scoring. Plus, listen to every broadcast from the Auburn Sports Network, even when multiple games are happening simultaneously on the official mobile app of Auburn Athletics, the Auburn Game Day app. Download it now.
It's game day. What do you take to the tailgate? A flat screen TV? Take it to the tailgate. Your wife's favorite blender? The DJ sound system? With a Ford F-150 truck, you can take it all. With available Pro Power onboard that acts like a mobile generator, you can use F-150 to take your tailgate to the next level. Visit your local Ford dealer today. The Auburn Tigers and Ford F-150. Greatness starts here. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
The game has changed, and the future of Auburn athletics now demands a strong NIL program. I'm Jason Campbell. Let's come together, Auburn family, and make a lasting impact. Visit OwnToVictory.com. Every dollar you contribute to Own to Victory helps create NIL opportunities for our student athletes. Visit www.OwnToVictory.com and be a part of changing the game for Auburn athletics.
To more of the Truck Works Halftime Report. Truck Works is the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Once again, here's Paul Ellen.
Five turnovers in the first half, three by Auburn, two by California. All the points in the first half came after turnovers. The Auburn Tigers got out to a disastrous start. It could have been much, much worse, but the Tiger defense rose up and kept it from getting too bad early on. Third play of the game, Peyton Thorne on a scramble play for Auburn fumbled the ball. It was recovered by Cal at the Auburn 35-yard line. Didn't take them long to take advantage. They made a quick first down, and then finally on a third and two, they were held short, and Michael Lookhurst came in and kicked a 39-yard field goal to give Cal a 3-0 lead. The Auburn defense able to rise up and hold Cal despite giving up the ball deep in Auburn territory. On the ensuing kickoff, Auburn got a penalty, had to start at their own 6-yard line. They went three and out after a sack on a third and two. As a result, Cal started at the Auburn 33-yard line. They made another quick first down, but then the Auburn defense stiffened again. Lookhurst was wide right on a field goal attempt, and it stayed 3-0. Auburn was able to move the ball for one first down to tilt the field situation a little bit, but then had to punt it away. The Tiger defense held a three and out, and we had an exchange of punts until we went early in the second quarter. At that point, the first break of the game, from a turnover standpoint, to at midfield at least, tilted the ball in Auburn's favor as Cal tried to run it from their own 17-yard line after a good Auburn punt. Fonse checks at the tailback spot, replacing Jaden Ott for Cal. A week ago, 10 carries, 54 yards, and three touchdowns at North Texas. And he will get the carry. He bounces to the outside. Good pursuit by Auburn. Ball is loose. Ball is loose. It's picked up by the Tigers at the 16-yard line. It was forced by Donovan Kaufman. He stripped the ball out. Asante picked it up, returned it a yard or so to the Auburn 17 officially, and that allowed the Tigers a chance to get on the scoreboard as they took advantage on a third and six situation. Thorne from the gun. Cal rushes four. Thorne throws across the middle. Jay Fair, he's to the 10, he's to the 5, he's in! Touchdown, Auburn! Jay Fair, the crossing route, 13 yards and a score, and Auburn takes the lead. The Auburn drive covered 17 yards in three plays after the turnover. Auburn had a 7-3 lead with 11:50 to go in the first half. The Auburn defense stuffed Cal again. Auburn getting the ball in good field position at their own 39-yard line, moved it down the field in a good situation. Damari Alston with a run into Cal territory would have had Auburn in good shape, but he coughed it up and Cal recovered at their 35-yard line. Sam Jackson came in, and between the turnover and Jackson coming in at quarterback, it tilted the momentum back in favor of Cal. As Jackson took him down the field, Jaden Ott running the ball, Jackson throwing the ball. Eventually, they had it set up at the Auburn 14-yard line.
Jackson from the gun. Ball at the right hash mark. Double wide receivers to the wide side of the field. He hands the ball to Ott. Ott at the two. Head down, dives forward. Touchdown, Cal.
I took it in from 14 out to cap a 65-yard six-play drive. And with just under 5 minutes to go in the half, Cal had reclaimed the lead at 10-7. Auburn went three and out. Cal moved to a first down, but then had to punt the ball away. But then on the first play of the ensuing possession from the Auburn 24-yard line, Thorne was intercepted, and Cal again had the ball in great field position at their 34-yard line. They were going to try a field goal by Luckhurst, and in fact did kick it successfully from 52 yards out, but it was nullified by a holding penalty against one of the Auburn rushers. So on 4th and 25, they just threw the ball up for grabs in the end zone. Jalen Simpson intercepted, ran it back out to about the 30-yard line, and that is where the half ended. So all points on turnovers, a sloppy first half, 5 turnovers combined, 3 by Auburn and 2 by Cal. We are at halftime. It is California 10, Auburn 7. Stay with us. We'll have a look at your halftime stats when the Truckworks Halftime Report continues in a moment.
Andy Burcham here to tell you about our friends over at Truckworks, the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Truckworks is Alabama's exclusive Kenworth, Hino, and Isuzu commercial truck dealer, and the Southeast headquarters for dump trucks, sleeper trucks, box vans, and everything in between. Step into their TRP parts store in Opelika for all your commercial truck, trailer, and bus parts needs. Truckworks, the partner you can count on in the transportation industry since 1978.
Recruiting plays a major role in team building. Recruiting also plays an important role in protecting my home from termites with Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon system. Termites eat the bait in the Centricon stations, then eagerly recruit other termites to also feed on the bait, thus eliminating the termite colony. You don't have to live with termites. Call Cook's Pest Control for a free quote.
Looky, looky, looky.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
Halftime, Cal leads Auburn 10-7. Your halftime statistics are presented by the Alabama Department of Public Health. They remind you, don't wait, vaccinate. Protect yourself and others by staying current on all recommended vaccines, including COVID and flu. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM. Well, at halftime, as we mentioned, turnovers are the big stat. Auburn with 3 of them, Cal with 2. Total yardage, Auburn just 99 yards. The Golden Bears had 129. Through the air, Auburn passed for just 38 yards. They ran the ball for 61 yards, and Auburn had four penalties for 26 yards. Cal, 72 yards in the air, 57 on the ground. They had 20 yards in penalties, including that big 10-yarder near the end of the half that took 3 points off the board. Cal has 8 first downs to just 4 for Auburn. On third down, the Tigers 1-for-6. The Golden Bears are 3-for-10. They also were 1-for-2 on fourth down conversions. Auburn just snapped the ball 27 times in the first half. Cal with 39 snaps in the first half. Neither offense very effective in the first half of play. In the red zone, Auburn 1-for-1, and Cal went 1-for-2 in the first half of play. Each team had 1 sack, and each team had 2 tackles for loss. Individually, Peyton Thorne, 5-for-9 passing, 38 yards, 1 touchdown, and 1 interception. Robbie Ashford was 1-for-2 for no net yards. Ben Finley was 7-for-11 for Cal for 34 yards. And Sam Jackson, 4-for-8 for 38 yards with 1 interception. On the ground, Demary Alston, 3 carries for 32 yards for Auburn. Peyton Thorne ran 6 times for 13 yards. Jarquez Hunter, 5 carries for 12 yards. Jaden Knott, 14 carries. He carried the load for the Golden Bears, 63 yards and a touchdown. Jay Fair, another touchdown catch for Auburn, 1 catch for 13 yards. Demary Alston, 1 catch for 8 yards in the first half. Jeremiah Hunter led all receivers, 5 catches for 35 yards in the first half for Cal. Monroe Young had 4 catches for 25 yards. So that's a look at your halftime statistics. Again, the story really turnovers. Cal had a slight advantage there, 3-2. As a result, Cal leads at halftime by 3 points, 10-7. It was a defensive-minded first half. We'll see what the halftime adjustments are made by the two respective coaches. So 10-7, Cal leads at halftime. We'll get set for the second half in just a moment. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
The Houston Clinic would like to welcome Dr. Brad Young, the newest addition to our team of experienced medical professionals at Auburn's Houston Clinic. Specializing in joint replacements, sports medicine, and arthroscopic surgery, Dr. Young has treated athletes and worked with sports teams from middle and high school to college and professional teams. Call now to schedule your evaluation. Houston Clinic. Research, education, treatment. Houston.com.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promising.
Thinking of advancing your career with a master's degree in business? If so, consider the graduate degree choices at Auburn University's Herbert College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best, we offer full-time and online programs in finance, supply chain management, information systems, accounting, and business administration. Learn more at herbert.auburn.edu.
Andy Burcham here to tell you about our friends over at Truckworks, the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Truckworks is Alabama's exclusive Kenworth, Hino, and Isuzu commercial truck dealer, and the Southeast headquarters for dump trucks, sleeper trucks, box vans, and everything in between. Step into their TRP parts store in Opelika for all your commercial truck, trailer, and bus parts needs. Truckworks, the partner you can count on in the transportation industry since 1978.
Halftime at Cal Memorial Stadium. The Bears lead the Tigers 10-7. Along with Jason Campbell, Will Herring, Paul Ellen, Gene Dulaney, Brad Law, Patrick Tisdale, and Ben Harling. I'm Andy Burcham. 10-7. It could be worse for Auburn, Jason Campbell.
Yeah, Auburn's defense has done a really good job against sudden change. You know, the turnovers, they only give up 3 points. And then I know Bears drove down the field and got 7 on that 1 turnover, but at the same time, this could be a 17 17. They could have 17, but on the flip side, though, Andy,
yeah,
we could be up 14-3.
Agreed. When Auburn fumbled at the 35, the Tigers were moving with Damari Alston, and he fumbled at the 35, and that's when the first half momentum changed. Take it to the house this football season with the Alabama Manufactured Housing Association and the Auburn Tigers. For home SEC games, if Auburn returns his first received kickoff of the second half for a touchdown, one lucky fan will win up to $75,000 towards the purchase of a manufactured home from an authorized AMHA dealer. Register today at auburntigers.com/take-it-to-the-house. With Auburn trailing 10-7, and the way the momentum went back and forth in the first half of play, it'll be very interesting. This first defensive stand for Auburn, I think, is very, very big. We'll put a pin in that. We'll send it downstairs, a Cook Pest Control sideline report. Here's William Herring.
Yeah, guys, the body language is spectacular. This defense, y'all, played a really good first half. They stood up several times. Going into the game, guys, we talked about, I mean, even Coach Freeze talked about they're going to move the ball. They're going to score points. We got to make them kick field goals. And, guys, the best player on the Bears is their running back. And I don't know what his yards per carry was, but we did a great job of shutting down that run. And we just got to stop turning the ball over and shooting ourselves in the foot, guys.
Jay Knott, 14 carries for 63 yards, 4.5 yards per carry in the first half. Damari Alston, 3 carries, 32 yards, but a fumble. Jarquez Hunter getting his first action of the year, 5 carries for 12 yards for Auburn. Auburn's run game right now, only 3.8 yards per carry in the first half of play.
Yeah, that's shocking. We thought that we can come in here and move the ball a little bit against their defensive front, but we've heard it pregame, though, Andy. They talked about this may be their best defense they've seen in the last 10 years for the Cal Bears. So sometimes you got to be a little bit more patient, but at the same time, we need to get better drive setters going. We got to get our receivers more involved in the offense, and we got to get Peyton more into a rhythm.
Lumagia Hearns III will take this kickoff from Alex McPherson. Low line drive. He takes it at the 2. Tries to get to the Cal sideline, and he gets to the 19-yard line before he's taken down on the play.
Jarquez Hunter in there on tackle.
First down for Cal at its own 20-yard line. Auburn's leading tacklers in the first half. Larry Nixon III with 4. DJ James with 3. And again, it's Jackson that opens the second half at quarterback from the 20 with Jay Knott as the tailback. Jackson won the battle. He started last week at North Texas, injured his shoulder in the second quarter. Brings a man in motion. Hands off to Ott, tries to bounce to the Cal sideline. Good pursuit for Auburn, and Ott gets a yard on the play. Keontae Scott came flying in after a gain of 2 on the play, second down and 8.
Yeah, you mentioned great pursuit. Great job by Eugene Asante again, helping spill that play outside. He's involved almost on every other play in this game.
From the left hash, second down and 8 from the Cal 21. And Jalen McLeod is down.
Timeout
at the line of scrimmage.
Player.
He's sitting up. And Auburn's athletic training staff is out to tend to the junior out of Washington, D.C., transfer from Appalachian State. He gets up, and McLeod will walk off the field under his own power.
And McLeod recovering from a sore ankle. Not sure if that's what it is here.
He trots off the field. And we'll pay attention to McLeod on the sideline. He's going to test that ankle, it appears, Jason, on the Auburn sideline.
Yeah, he came into this game. He missed last week's game with that sore ankle. Been trying to recover and get back to full strength.
Second and 8 from the 21 for Cal. Tight end goes in motion. Sets up outside the left tackle for the Golden Bears. Jackson drops to throw, now rolls. Sets and he throws. It is complete across the middle for a first down for Cal out to the 31-yard line to Taj Davis, 6'1 redshirt junior from Upland, California, transfer out of Washington. Boy, he was wide open. First down to the 31 for Cal. Jackson, hands up the middle. Ott for a couple yards to the 34 before he stood up. 3 yards on the gain for Jaden Ott.
Yeah, got Elijah McAllister in there again on another tackle. Also got Jason Jones again in on the tackle as well. Talk about a couple of guys of Auburn right defense right there.
Ott out of Chino, California. Rushed for 897 yards and 8 touchdowns in a freshman All-American season last season. Second and 7 from the 34. Jackson from the gun. Again to Ott. Pushes the pile to the 37 before he's finally brought down. It will bring up third down and about 4 for Cal.
Great job by Moselle Kite getting in there, not allowing to get pushed. The Cal Bears offense gets pushed on the defensive line. Our defensive line is standing their own, Andy, for the most part when they try to run up the middle.
Here's third and 4 for Cal. In the first half, Cal was 3 of 10 on third down. Couple speedsters in that backfield. One of them now comes in motion. Jackson, quarterback draw. Jackson shy of the first down. He's taken down at the 40. He's going to be a yard shy of the first down.
What a hit by Eugene Asante right there. Jackson, like he's about to pick up the first down. Eugene came in and laid the lumber, making this a 4th and 1.
And Cal will go for it. They bring in a heavy set. Jack Endries, the tight end, checks in. Double wide receivers to the Cal boundary. 4th and 1 for Cal and its own 40. Jackson brings a man in motion. Hands the ball tailback, first down out to the 46. The carry by Ashton Stredick, a redshirt sophomore from Needville, Texas.
Yeah, they tried to motion across the receiver right there to disguise the defense, and they ran that ball backside, weak side, found an open hole right there for the first down.
Out to the 46, first down. Cal now 2 of 3 on fourth down tonight. They were 3 of 3 last week at North Texas. First down and 10 for the Bears. Endries in motion. Hand the ball to Stredick. Stredick for 3 yards. Make it 2 out to the 47. Make that the 48.
Yeah, Moselle Kite with the initial hit right there. Finish off by Eugene Asante.
Kite's been active tonight. Transfer from Maryland out of Pittsburgh. He was an honorable mention all Big Ten a year ago on the Polynesian Player of the Year watch list. McLeod back into the lineup for Auburn on that defensive front. 2nd and 8. High snap. Stredick around left side. Gets inside Auburn territory. Taken down at the 48. Jalen McLeod, who just checked back in with the stop.
Yeah, that was close to being out the gate right there. Good job by Jalen McLeod coming back in, getting on that tackle. I think his ankle might have been a little sore. You play that first half and then you go sit for halftime. Sometimes that ankle can get a little sore. I think it's loosening back up for him now.
Stredick out, Ott in a tailback on 3rd and 4 for Cal at the Auburn 48. Ball at the left hash. Jackson from the gun. Sends Ott in motion. Jackson turns that way. He flips it to Ott. Ott across the 45 and a first down for Cal. Larry Nixon the third with the stop, but not before Ott got enough. 5 yards from the first down. Cal first down and 10 at the Auburn 43. Initial drive of the second half for Cal. Leading Auburn 10-7. Excuse me, Jason.
No, you good.
At the Auburn 43-yard line, first down for Cal. 3-man set up front for Auburn. Jackson to throw. Late rush by Auburn. Jackson flushed, in trouble. Now really in trouble. He throws it and he throws it away. He got enough room just to chuck that one.
Great pursuit by the Auburn defense by not allowing Jackson to get outside. You know he wants to get outside, get on the edge where he feels most comfortable, where he can see things down the field and utilize his speed. Great job by the Auburn defense.
Great contain, Eugene Asante and Keldrick Falk.
Great job by the young freshman Falk right there. Eugene has been all over the field tonight.
Second and 10 from the Auburn 43. Stretic back in at tailback. Stretic gets the carry. Stretic inside the 40-yard line, down to the Auburn 37. Good carry on second down for Ashton Stretic.
We're going to make it a third and four here. Big stand for the Auburn defense right here. We rotate defensive linemen in, try to get some fresh guys out there. We better get there in a hurry.
Stretic had 5 carries all of last year. He's got 4 on this drive alone. Third and 4 for the Bears. Play clock at 13 as Jackson looks to the sideline. Stretic the tailback, flanks him to the right. Play action, Jackson throws, back shoulder throw incomplete. Intended for Jeremiah Hunter, good coverage by Zion Puckett for Auburn. Excuse me, DJ James on the coverage.
Yeah, great job by DJ James, not letting the receiver beat him down the field. Great coverage, expecting the back shoulder throw. We've seen a lot of third downs, third and shorts tonight where both teams have tried to throw the back shoulder.
Cal's going to go for it on fourth and 4 at the Auburn 37. Need to get to the Auburn 33 for the first down. Stretic in motion out of the backfield. Auburn blitzes. They float it to Stretic, and Stretic is taken down after a 1-yard game and Auburn defense holds. It was Jalen McLeod that took down Stretic.
Yes, great job by Jalen McLeod with the assist from Wesley Steiner there as well. Great job by the Auburn defense to turn this ball over, giving it back to the offense. Great job, Auburn defense.
Cal went for fourth down twice on that drive. The second time came up empty. Auburn ball when we return. First drive for the Tigers from its own 34. 8:20 to go in the third quarter. Cal 10, Auburn 7. And Auburn football continues in a moment.
It's the classic dilemma at Whataburger. You pick up your all-time favorite patty melt with 2 fresh all-beef patties, melted Monterey Jack cheese, grilled onions, and creamy pepper sauce. And just when you're about to dig in to Whataburger's take on this delicious all-time classic, someone utters the dreaded words.
Can I have a bite?
Should you? Shouldn't you? Maybe you should just take a big bite so you don't have to answer. Ooh, glad that dilemma's over. The Whataburger Patty Melt, just like you like it. Order online to earn rewards.
The game has changed, and the future of Auburn athletics now demands a strong NIL program. I'm Jason Campbell. Let's come together, Auburn family, and make a lasting impact. Visit ontovictory.com. Every dollar you contribute to On to Victory helps create NIL opportunities for our student athletes. Visit www.ontovictory.com and be a part of changing the game for Auburn athletics.
I'm Ty Burrell, actor and small business owner. I'm going to show you my steps for making the perfect radio ad. This one's about innovation refunds and the ERC. First step, be relatable. I like pizza and puppies. 2, cold hard info. The ERC is a tax credit for eligible businesses that kept employees on payroll in 2020 and 2021. So if you qualify, Innovation Refunds Network of Independent Tax Attorneys could help you claim it. 3, go to innovationrefunds.com or call 1-843-REFUNDS.
Innovation Refunds does not provide tax or legal advice. We work with an independent network of tax professionals. Terms and conditions apply. Ty is a paid spokesman.
Everything that you'd ever seen with Miranda Lambert on it, I have my finger on the pulse of what it is. Out of Wind, I've seen every article of clothing. I've spent hours and hours sending inspirations. I've sent clothes that I love and fabrics, and I'm involved in every single garment that you see. It's important to me that it is an extension of my music, and it's an extension of who I am. I always want it to stay as honest as my music.
Out of Wind at Boot Barn.
First down, Auburn. Initial drive of the third quarter for the Tigers after Auburn held on fourth down. Tigers scrimmage from their own 36. Just inside the right hash mark, Peyton Thorne is the quarterback for the Tigers. In front of Jarquez Hunter. Hunter with the carry right up the middle, 45, 50-yard line. Jarquez Hunter taken down at the 50. A 14-yard gain on first down for Jarquez.
Ooh, that almost been out the gate for a touchdown right there. Shoe-saving screen tackle.
8 minutes to go in the third. Tigers trail 10-7. Thorne to Jarquez around right end, and Jarquez fights his way to the Cal 45-and-a-half yard line before he's brought down. Good second, third effort by Jarquez Hunter, the junior out of Philadelphia, Mississippi, getting his first action of the season tonight.
Got a two tight end set here, Andy.
Second and five from the Cal 45. Thorne, the quarterback, turns, he hands the ball. Jarquez Hunter gets 2 yards going off the left side.
Well, they're going to be third and three here, third and about three and a half here.
Auburn was not very good on third down in the first half, just 1 of 6, and Robbie Ashford is in at quarterback for the Tigers on third and a 3.
Look for this to be an RPO run pass option right here for Robbie Ashford.
He has Jarquez Hunter in the backfield with him. Rivaldo Fairweather is the tight end, double tight end on the left side. Ashford hands the ball. Jarquez Hunter didn't get it. Jarquez Hunter is 2 yards shy of the first down. Now, does Auburn go for it on fourth down or look at a field goal of over 50 yards?
No, they're going to go for it here, Andy.
All right.
Big fourth down here for Auburn. Let's see if the big guys up front can move some weight around and create a hole.
Camden Brown checks in. Jay Fair checks in for Auburn. And Amari Kelly. Down to 10 on the play clock, and Ashford still doesn't have the call yet.
I'm going to take a timeout here.
They're going to have to. Yep. Play clock's down to 3 as Robbie Ashford calls Auburn's first timeout of the second half.
Timeout. Auburn.
Fourth and 2 for Auburn when play resumes from the Cal 42-yard line. Bears lead the Tigers 10-7 at the 6:03 mark of the third quarter. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Kia of Auburn is happy to connect the Kia brand to the Auburn fans. Our winning lineup has something for everyone at almost any budget. SUVs like the Telluride, Sorento, and Sportage. You prefer a sedan? Check out the Rio, Forte, Soul, or the Sporty Stinger. And don't forget our new multi-purpose vehicles, the Carnival, or our amazing hybrid or electric vehicles. Kia of Auburn is a proud supporter of Auburn Athletics. Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one. Whoa, Rico.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
Jairus McIntyre, former Auburn wide receiver.
You know, it just was crazy that it took that long for us to score a touchdown with Ronnie Brown on the team, Cadillac Williams, myself, Courtney Taylor, Jason Campbell was the quarterback, Devin Aromashu, Ben Obamanu. We were loaded, and we can score in 2 games. I could just remember catching that pass like, I got to get in the end zone. We got to score. We got to get this monkey off our back. And I still watch that play to this day. I still listen to his call to this day. And, you know, I think that's probably the most memorable moment of my Auburn football career outside of, you know, go crazy Cadillac running down that sideline with that.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
Hey, Auburn fans, it's Coach Freeze. Few plays are more exciting than the sack. For every Auburn sack this season, a donation is made to help the Ascension St. Vincent's Foundation invest in PE equipment for schools around the state. Cultivating a healthy lifestyle early helps prevent chronic diseases. Please join Jill and me by making a donation to SAC Childhood Obesity. Visit stvhsfoundation.org, War Eagle.
All right, here's 4th and 2 for Auburn at the Cal 42. Jarquez Hunter, the tailback. Robbie Ashford is the quarterback. Ball in the middle of the field.
Yeah, you got a wing set to the left down here. We got 3 tight ends in the game. See if we go off that right, off this left side again here, Andy.
Double tight ends. Well, all 3 tight ends set up on the left side of the Auburn offensive line. On 4th and 2 from the Cal 42. The snap to Ashford. He runs to the Auburn boundary. Robbie Ashford down at the 41, and he didn't get it.
Yeah, we tried to run behind a three tight end set there, try to create some separation, get Robbie a room to get in there. Great play by the Bears defense. Figured they'd expect that one later. Three times last week against UMass for touchdowns.
Just ran out of room at the sideline before he could turn up field. Came up about a yard shy.
Yeah, when we get more comfortable in our offense, got Camden Brown one-on-one up top in the man coverage situation right there, where you can kind of throw that backside slant. It's open because the wheel linebacker's tucked in, but we're just not that comfortable yet to call that play.
Both teams come up empty on fourth down in this third quarter. Cal leads it 10-7, 5:57 to go in the third. First and 10 for the Bears at their own 41. Flip out to the left side. Good pursuit by Auburn as DJ James runs the man out of bounds. A 2-yard gain on the play for Cal. The pass to Trond Grizel.
Eugene Asante not in there right now, does it look like?
Second,
there he is in the slot.
Second and 8 from the Cal 43. Sam Jackson, the fifth, out of the gun from the left hash. Tries to throw, he does. Has a man open across midfield, Auburn 40-yard line. Well, first down for the Bears. That was Grizel again.
Yeah, that was a great play by Jackson, though, as a quarterback. Jalen Simpson came from a safety blitz, got in his face, but Jackson saw him quick enough to deliver the ball.
17-yard gain for Grizel to the Auburn 40. Cal leads the Bears 10-7, under 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Snap to Jackson with some time, and he throws, and it's almost intercepted. Zion Puckett was closer to that one than Grizel, the intended receiver.
Yeah, great defense by Zion Puckett there. Grizel got a height size on Zion, but Zion's a little bit more of a physical safety right there. Great job by him.
Marcus Harris in for Auburn. Lawrence Johnson out in the middle of that Auburn defensive front. Second and 10 from the Auburn 40. Jackson from the right hash. Hands the ball to Jaden Ott, and Ott taking down a shoestring tackle at the 40 or the 39-yard line. First stop, Justin Rogers.
And again, Asante's in there again on another tackle.
Gene Asante, the 6'1 junior from Alexandria, Virginia. You heard talking with Brad Law. Countdown to kickoff. How proud he is to be aware from that Washington, D.C. area. Third and 9 from the Auburn 39. Ball in the middle of the field. Brings a tight end in motion. Hand off to Ott. Right up the middle, and Ott is going to be about 3 yards shy of the first down.
Ooh, that was scary there, ain't it? Look, we brought both corner blitzes off the edges there. I mean, both slot blitzes off the edge, trying to create some pressure on the quarterback, and they almost hit us with a run up the middle.
They mark him down at the 35, so this is 4th and 5 for Cal. Cal 2 for 4 on 4th down in the game, 1 for 2 in the third quarter. Long snap count for Jackson. Play clock at 6. There's the snap. Jackson, quarterback draw. He's got all the room. He's inside the 30 and out of bounds at the 23-yard line.
Yeah, that's something you got to be aware of right there. When you spread everybody out on defense, be aware of a fast quarterback that they're creating space for a quarterback draw.
11 yards. First down for Cal. To the Auburn 23-yard line. Ball at the right hash. Hunter, wide left, double wide receivers to the short side of the field, the Auburn boundary. Now Hunter comes in motion. Jackson looks that way, and throws it away.
Edge pressure again by Asante again. Coming off the blitz off the slot down here in the boundary.
Had 6 tackles, 1.5 tackles for loss, a half sack last week. Boy, he's been all over the place tonight. Second in the 10 from the Auburn 23 for Cal. Bears lead the Tigers 10-7, 2:55 to go in the third quarter of play. Jackson brings Ott to his right, hands it to Ott, tries to bounce to the outside. Ott hurdles a man and is taken down for it.
Great hit by Jalen Simpson, man.
And Ott is slow to get up. Ott tried to hurdle, and I don't know if he was trying to hurdle Jalen, but Jalen's the one that brought him down. No gain on the play.
Yeah, it looked like he was trying to jump over.
Timeout for an injured player.
He bounced it outside. Good pursuit. He tried to jump over two Auburn players there, yeah. Eugene Asante and Jalen Simpson. And they are attending to Ott right now. Third and 10 when we come back from the Auburn 23. Cal leads Auburn 10-7, 2:44 in the third. Auburn football continues in a moment.
Kaneka sausage is a fan favorite for tailgating, always great on the grill, and it's the official sausage dog and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, their patented blend of seasonings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Be sure to visit the Kaneka gift shop in Evergreen, Alabama, right off I-65 at exit 96. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka sausage dog while watching the Tigers and make Kaneka part of your game day. Kaneka sausage, since 1947, a real winner.
Who out there likes to eat chicken? Did you know that when it comes to chicken production, Alabama rules the roost? In fact, we're ranked second in the country in broiler production. That's meat-type chickens, with nearly 2,600 poultry farm families raising more than a billion birds a year. Alabama's poultry industry adds more than $15 billion a year to the state's economy and provides jobs for almost 90,000 Alabamians. So be sure to prepare your favorite chicken dish this football season.
Yellowwood knows that a five-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories. Like cookouts. Cornhole with friends. Ooh, a neighborhood potluck with your wife's pasta salad. The one with the feta. Oh, sorry. Or taking a nap on your deck in a hammock. Naps are memories. I love naps. For five-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
You're listening to Auburn football. Back to more of the Tigers and Bears.
Jan and Ott tried to hurdle an Auburn defender. Asante and Simpson took him down. He landed, we could see, on his back and just was able to get up and walk off the field and into the injury tent for Cal. Auburn University isn't just home to the best athletics program in the nation. It's also home to the best student-centered engineering experience in America. That's not just a slogan, it's a promise. Find your future at the Samuel Ginn College of Engineering. Visit eng.auburn.edu. Third and 10 for the Bears at the Auburn 23.
Yeah, Andy, I played on turf before and grass. You'd much rather that grass gives a little bit more when you jump that high in the air. That turf, you bounce up off that concrete that's underneath that turf, and sometimes it doesn't feel too good.
First time for Auburn on an artificial surface since the 2021 Birmingham Bowl against Houston.
Big third and 10 right here. Auburn got to try to hold these guys to a field goal. That'd be a big win in this situation.
Ashton Stretic replaces Ott in the backfield for Cal, flanking Sam Jackson the fifth. And it's a pitch to Stretic. Stretic trying to get to the Auburn boundary, and he's taken down at the 26.
Man, great pursuit by Eugene Asante again, coming up with a big hit.
He got some help from Donovan Kaufman as well.
Man, these guys are laying a hammer to the nail tonight defensively. They've gotten Auburn out of some bad situations. This score could be a lot different, but this Auburn defense has showed up to play tonight. It was going to be a great flight home for these guys. This
will be a 43-yard field goal attempt for Michael Luckhurst. Asante now 9 tackles in the game. From the right hash for Luckhurst. The holder is the punter, Wilson. Snap is down. The kick is on the way by Luckhurst, and it is wide right.
Man, what a job by this Auburn defense. Have created 2 missed field goals. That time they showed like they was going to bring Jalen Simpson off the edge, and they brought the pressure from the opposite side to force that field goal wide.
It's been a stalemate in the third quarter. A missed field goal, and both teams have come up empty on fourth down tries. And the score remains Cal 10, Auburn 7, with a minute 51 to go in the third. Remember, both of these teams scored over 50 last week apiece. Who'd have thought right now we'd have 17 total points in this game?
Auburn has got to take the bull by the horn right there. Robbie Ashford is still the quarterback in the game at the moment.
And Damari Alston is in for the first time since he fumbled at the Cal 35-yard line. And he lines up in the eye behind Ashford in the shotgun. Handoff. No, it's Ashford around left end. Gets to the 30, eludes one man. Hit by the second guy, runs forward. He is close to the first down.
Yeah,
is across the 35, and he may have the Auburn first down. Looks like it'll be about a half-yard shy.
Yeah, got a lot of help from big, two-tall Miller getting out there on the edge and get behind Jarquez and pushing him.
It is a first down. Cobb was in on that play. He went in a misdirection the right side. Hunter now comes in at tailback for Auburn. Ashford, the quarterback. First and 10 for Auburn from its own 35-yard line. And it's a reverse. Cobb trying to get upfield. Cobb to the 40, 45, 50. Sideline and a flag is downfield.
Gosh, what a great play call right there by Coach Montgomery. Great block by Robbie Ashford, but this one is coming back. Too tall Miller. Got to let the guy go once you got an open space and let your playmakers make a guy miss.
That was going to be a first down at the Cal 40.
Holding. Offense, number 72. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Ah, that's a shame right there. Too tall, got to learn from that one. You got your running backs coming back in the reverse in open space. You got to let your playmaker just outrun that defender. Just got to know when to let him go.
So first, instead of first and 10 at the Cal 40, it's second or first and 11 for Auburn now from its own 35-yard line. Cobb and Hunter flank Robbie Ashford in the shotgun for Auburn. Ashford will keep it himself. Tries to bounce to the outside. He's in trouble. And he's taken down on the play. Kalen Moore, the nickelback, came up to make the stop.
Yeah, it looked like they wanted Robbie to hand that one off to Jeremiah Cobb that time or Hunter, but that played like it was busted from the start.
Auburn going backwards, third down and 12 now, and Thorne checks into the game for Auburn. Excuse me, second down and 12, my mistake. Thorne hands off, that's Damari Alston, gets to the 35, to the original line of scrimmage, gets another yard. It's going to bring up third down
that
and nine,
the third quarter
has come to a close. We go to the fourth quarter. Auburn third and nine at its own 36 when play resumes. Cal 10, Auburn 7. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Fine Dining meets Southern Comfort at Vintage 2298, Auburn's newest fine dining restaurant and butcher shop. Chef Randall Baldwin and wife Laura present Gulf cuisine with a Southern flair made fresh farm to table. Seasonal meats, cheeses, wine, and handcrafted cocktails available next door at the butcher shop. Manager Stephen Jacobs and staff bring a new level of service to local dining at Vintage 2298. Private dining and event space available, as well as awesome tailgate packages found in the butcher shop. Experience Vintage 2298.
Southeastern Industrial Contractors offers the path to a productive and successful career for hard workers of all ages, especially young people looking to jump straight into the workforce. Southeastern Industrial Contractors is now hiring for great-paying, skilled trade positions. Managing partner Derek Harville is a proud Auburn University graduate with deep roots in the community. Give him a call at 334-209-6355 to learn more. Southeastern Industrial Contractors, 334-209-6355.
You will love Buff City Soap. Their soap bars, oils, body butters, bath bombs, and laundry soaps are wonderful. Handmade and customized for you using plant-based ingredients that delight your skin and your nose. See partywithbuff.com and bring your kids or friends to make some magic. Buff City is also fantastic for gifts or fundraisers for your organization. Located in the 320 West Magnolia Building with a downtown Auburn Chick-fil-A and convenient parking. Buff City Soap. Plant-based and handmade daily so you smell wonderful.
From the very beginning in 1907, Auburn Bank's mission has been to promote our community.
see businesses flourish, and improve the livelihoods of local citizens. We have operated a simple and straightforward business model, built on a foundation of sound business decisions and a caring response. Our local team stands ready to discuss your financial needs and goals. Auburn Bank, champions of you. Member FDIC. Online at auburnbank.com.
Cal completely controlled the third quarter, but as we move to fourth quarter action, Auburn has the ball, and we're right where we were at halftime. Cal leading by a score of 10-7. This game recap sponsored by Wind Creek Casino and Hotel with three Alabama locations in Athmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka. You can escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and Hotel and at windcreekcasino.com. Cal controlled the ball 22 plays to just 9 for Auburn. They had it for 11 minutes, and they moved for 79 total yards. But big plays by the Auburn defense kept Cal from scoring, along with a missed field goal from 42 yards. As a result, we're right where we were at halftime. No turnovers by either team in the third quarter, and Cal leads Auburn 10-7. The Tigers with the ball facing third and long as we go to fourth quarter action with a call from Andy Burcham.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. Before we get there, let's pause 10 seconds so stations like WPFL in Flemington can identify themselves on the Auburn Sports Network. The fourth quarter starts for Auburn, third and 10 at its own 34-yard line.
Big third down here. Peyton Thorne back in at the quarterback position. We go trips to the right.
Thorne with Alston flanking him, and a flag is thrown.
Yeah, they're going to get Shane Hooks.
Offense, number 3, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Right in front of the linesman, Shane Hooks. Boy, penalties have just been killers for Auburn tonight.
We got Jeremiah Cobb just checked in the game for Damari Alston. May look for a screen to try to get the ball to him in open space.
The wide side of the field is the Auburn boundary. And Auburn has three receivers there. And they bring Cobb in motion that way. Thorne looks that way, throws it up the flat, intended for Jay Fair, and behind him, an incomplete.
Yeah, try to throw a seam ball with Jay Fair there. Try to get him up the field. I'm trying to tell if that ball was a little bit behind him.
He had him open.
Well, just got to put a little bit more mustard behind that throw right there. You're throwing those seam balls. Can't float those. Get a defender too much of an opportunity to come in there and make a play on it.
Chapman will punt it away for Auburn. Hunter to take this one. Chapman, low line drive. And it is recovered by the Cal deep man as he dove forward to get it on a bounce.
It's pretty dangerous by Jeremiah Hunter right there trying to come up and field that ball.
Low line drive kick, not the best of the night, just a 36-yarder for Chapman. And Cal will have first and 10 at its own 33-yard line. Cal leads Auburn 10-7. No scoring in the third quarter.
And I think our defense is going to have to create another turnover for us to give our offense a short field here.
Jackson remains the quarterback. Stretic. Excuse me, it's not Stretic. It's Afonso, the tailback. Play action. Jackson flips it to the near side. Up the field, out of the bounds at the Auburn, or the Cal 44-yard line. To number 9, Taj Davis.
Yeah, they brought Taj Davis from the backside, what we call a slide route out of the backfield from the backside receiver. The bootleg action right there and gave him the ball in open space.
11-yard gain out to the 44-yard line. 14:21 on the counting clock in the fourth. Afonso across midfield to the Auburn 49. That Auburn defense has been on the field a long time in this second half of play.
Yeah, Jalen McLeod and Eugene again on another tackle.
Second and 4. Afonso on the carry again. Tries to get outside. He does. bounces inside the Auburn 45 to the 44, and a first down for Cal.
Dunham and Kaufman coming up from the secondary, making that tackle right there. But defensively, we've got to stop. I think right now we're trying to get a substitution in the game, but we can't get out fast enough. Cal is going fast here in the fourth quarter.
First down from the Auburn 44 for the Bears. Isaiah Afonso, the tailback, flanking Jackson. Afonso with the carry. And Auburn wraps him up after a two-yard gain. He gets to the Tiger 41 and a half yard line. That was Lawrence Johnson with the catch, or with the tackle for Auburn.
Yeah, Larry Nissen coming off the
yes,
field, seemed to be holding his shoulder a little bit, yeah. Replaced by Steiner.
It was his right shoulder, it looked, or shoulder or arm that he was favoring coming off the field. Second and seven from the Auburn 41. Jackson now rolls to the Auburn boundary and he throws. It is complete at the 30 yard line and out of bounds to Brian Hightower.
Well, that was a design play right there by Jackson to make it look like a drop back, and then he flushed that out of pocket to give the outside receiver Hightower a chance, a big body runner comeback, short comeback route.
10-yard gain to the Auburn 31 for Cal. Best drive of the second half for the Bears. First down from the 31. Hendries, the tight end, goes in motion to the wide side. Slant route complete inside the 20. Down to the Auburn 16-yard line. These are quick hitters by Jackson, but he has been on the mark. That time to Taj Davis.
Yeah, Jackson, so athletic. You got to be aware of his running, creating the passing lanes in his fourth quarter.
First down at the Auburn 16-yard line. From the right hash. Play action to the end zone, in and out of the hands of Brian Hightower.
Yeah, great defense by DJ James right there to get his head around on that back shoulder throw. Hightower has the bigger size on DJ, but DJ did a good job of shilling him to the sideline, getting his head around, keeping that from being a touchdown.
Hugh Freeze said one of the big keys defensively tonight, he thought that Cal would be able to move the ball, but would Auburn be able to stop them in the red zone? Stredick back in at tailback for the Bears. Second and 10 from the Auburn 16. From the right hash, double wide receiver, short side of the field. Hightower to the wide side. Now they bring a man in motion to the wide side of the field. From the gun, Auburn brings the blitz. Jackson throws and he overthrows his man.
Great job by Coach Roberts bringing a delayed blitz right there. As soon as it would start out on two high shell, and as soon as they brought the motion, we went to a one high shell and called a blitz right there with Sante coming up through the gap right there, creating pressure to force that errant pass.
Taj Davis was the intended receiver, but it was well overthrown, so he had to get rid of it in a hurry. Here's third and 10 from the Auburn 14. Stredick flanks Jackson. He is even with Jackson in the backfield.
No safeties deep. Expect pressure from Auburn's defense here.
Play clock at six. Trips to the wide side of the field for Cal. They get the play away with one. Jackson taken down. Here comes the blitz. Eugene Asante.
Great job by Auburn defense. No safeties in the middle of the field, Andy. Usually when you see that, you're going to see edge pressure, some form of a blitz. That's exactly what Coach Roberts did.
And now instead of fourth down and short, this will be a field goal attempt by Michael Luckhurst of 44 yards from the right hash. He's missed a couple tonight. Snap down, Luckhurst's kick is on the way. And the kick is no good. Wide left, the defense holds again.
Again, Jalen Simpson with the pressure. He was held but not called again, but his presence has affected the kicking game of California tonight. Great job again by the Auburn defense. These guys are going to be sleeping good on their flight tonight.
Luckhurst was one of three in field goals last weekend. He has missed three more tonight. And it's a 10-7 Cal lead, 11:08 to go in the fourth. Auburn from its own 27 when we return. Auburn football continues in a moment.
Sports not only bring us together, they inspire us on our own health journeys. Whether we're walking an extra lap,
crushing a new goal. We're spending time with friends cheering in the stands. We all win when we feel healthier and happier. That's why Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Because a healthier Alabama is a happier Alabama. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters.
If SEC football runs deep in your veins, then SiriusXM SEC Radio is what you need to listen to. We're talking conference and team previews, plus hear live games, news, and analysis from experts like Chris Doering, Aaron Murray, and Max Stark. Go in-depth with your favorite team with coaches shows, championship specials, and more. Get inside SEC football like nowhere else. Feed your fandom on the SiriusXM app. Stay up to date anywhere you go. Just download the app and start streaming.
Hey y'all, this is Ronte, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the pimento cheese. I was like, go cheese, go pimento, go honey, go get it.
Hi, this is Chantrese, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the mild spiciness of the pickled jalapenos. No, it's the crispy chicken. Actually, I can't decide. It's the entire sandwich.
Order the honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Available for a limited time. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonials.
Auburn in the state of California is 0-3. Lost at Santa Clara in 1936. At number 18 USC at the Coliseum in 2002. And against number 1 Florida State in the BCS championship game at the Rose Bowl in 2014. It is time to snap the Golden State losing streak. Here is Auburn, first and 10 at its own 27 at the 11:08 mark of the fourth quarter. Cal 10, Auburn 7.
And we got to start taking some chances in our passing game. We've only attempted one pass in the second half. We're still in this game 10-7, but we got to be a little bit more aggressive here.
Robbie Ashford, the quarterback, hands the ball near side. Jeremiah Cobb tries to bounce outside, does across the 30, and taken out of bounds at the 33.
Man, speed kills. This guy can run.
Caleb Alarms Orr with the stop. A gain of 6 on first down. Well, I didn't see that he had an angle, but he got to the corner and got 6 yards on the play.
Yeah, he definitely created some open space right there with his legs.
Second and 4 for Auburn at the Tiger, 33-yard line. High snap, handball to Cobb. And Cobb has the Auburn first down, gets out to the 38-yard line. He needed 4, he got 5. First down, Auburn.
Seems like, Andy, we're going to hang our hat on running the football here and try to wear down the defense of the Cal Bears.
Jarquez Hunter in now. Play action by Ashford. Flushed out of the pocket to the Auburn boundary. Get rid of it. He does up the sideline. Oh. Almost threw it away. He almost was intercepted on the play. Caleb Alarms Orr had his hand on that ball.
Yeah, he almost threw it to Sermon, the defensive coordinator's son right there. Never want to throw the ball back across your body going towards the sideline. Ashford looks to be cramping up, throwing back in the game.
And he comes out, and he immediately goes to the turf, and they're going to work on his right leg. Thorn in, second and 10 for Auburn at the Tiger 38. Cobb, the tailback for Auburn. Thorn drops. He's in trouble. Down he goes at the 30-yard line. They brought the blitz off the side, and David Reese got it. I'm not sure Reese was touched.
Yeah, too tall. Miller got caught right there. Not shifting back a little bit for Reese. Got caught standing still. Reese shot by him. He's fast. You got to make sure you get off the ball on time if you're too tall, Miller.
Third and 17, Alston in at tailback for Auburn. Thorne walks to the line of scrimmage, looks to the Auburn bench for a call. Play clock at 10. They're roaring here in Berkeley. There's the snap to Peyton Thorne. He looks and he throws. It is caught! Fairweather at the 41 of Cal.
Great catch by Fairweather. Great job of Thorne stepping up in the pocket right there for a 28-yard gain. Fairweather, back shoulder throw, big target, 6'5".
He had to go down and get it. First down for Auburn at the Cal 41. Play action by Thorne.
And he's in trouble, and he goes down at the 45.
Thorne gonna wish he had that one back, Andy. They tried to run a seam route with Javaris Johnson. The corner sink from the boundary, but you had Omar Kelly sitting 9 to 10 yards open on the sideline. You got to stay with your progression. He got off of it too soon, tried to come back to the right, and end up getting tackled for a loss.
Jay Fair comes in for Auburn, replacing Javaris Johnson. A loss of 4 back to the 45, second and 14. Ball in the middle of the field for Peyton Thorne. Thorne, one step drop, throws complete. Jay Fair, 35, stays on his feet inside the 35 to the 33. And he'll be about 3 yards shy of the first down.
Yes, great pitch and catch right there by Fair. They're going to go fast right here. Third and 3 really quick for Auburn. Need a big conversion.
Third and 3 for Auburn at the Cal 33. Thorne from the gun, flips it out. Alston at the 30. He's down to the 25. Inside the 25 to the 22 and an Auburn first down. Nice. 11 yards on the game.
Nice rub route right there by Damari Alston. Great job by the receivers of getting there in man. Caught him in man coverage. Linebacker couldn't get out to cover Damari Alston. Great play call right there to get Auburn a first down.
First and 10 from the Cal 22. Clock rolls down, 7:43 in the fourth. Auburn trails 10-7. Play clock at 15 as Thorne looks to the Auburn boundary for the call. Alston flanks him. Play clock at 6. Down to 3. Down to 1. There's the snap. Play action. Thorne to the end zone. Fairweather.
Oh.
Can't get it. And there's a flag. It's going to be interference on Cal.
Yeah, you're going to get pass interference on Woodson right there, but that's a touchdown, though, Andy. We got to put that ball 3 yards out there in front of Fairweather and let him go. He has steps on Woodson right there for a touchdown.
Pass interference. Defense, number 3. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Nohai Williams saved the touchdown right there with that interference. Stops the clock with 7:18 in the fourth. Auburn in the Chick-fil-A red zone. First and goal for Auburn at the 7. Tigers trail 10-7. Thorne, the quarterback. Alston, the tailback for Auburn. Shane Hooks goes wide left. So does Cam Brown. He's in the slot. Fairweather, the tight end. Outside, another tight end. That's Luke Deal. Ball at the right hash. Thorne hands the ball. Alston cuts back at the 5. Puts his head down at the 5. And he's taken down at the 5. A 2-yard gain.
Nice cut by Alston right there. That play was supposed to go front side, backside shield. Great job of him cutting backside, picking up 3-4 yards right there.
Second and goal from the 5. Auburn trails 10-7. Under 7 minutes to go in the fourth quarter at Cal. Hooks and Brown, they're coming out now. Ashford in at quarterback. Double tight end set for Auburn. Fairweather. Actually, Auburn has 3 tight ends in right now. Play clock is down to 8. And Auburn's going to have to call a timeout. Stopping the clock with 6:36 to go in the fourth. Auburn second and goal from the Cal 5. The Bears lead the Tigers 10-7. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Presenting the all-new Aubie's Kids Club. Benefits include an exclusive Aubie-branded swag box or bag, T-shirt, membership card, access to exclusive Kids Club events, as well as free admission to non-conference baseball, softball, and women's basketball games. Members also get a monthly newsletter from Aubie, a special invitation to Aubie's birthday party, and a personalized birthday card. 2 membership options are available. Learn more and register at aubieskidsclub.com.
Sports not only bring us together, they inspire us on our own health journeys. Whether we're walking an extra lap, crushing a new goal, or spending time with friends cheering in the stands, we all win when we feel healthier and happier. That's why Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Because a healthier Alabama is a happier Alabama. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters.
What widens the eyes, tightens the stomach, and flutters the heart. Adrenaline.
Feel it for yourself in the Toyota RAV4, Camry, Corolla, and Tacoma. Get 2.9% APR for 36 months on a new 2023 Toyota RAV4. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through October 3rd, 2023. Zero down for well-qualified buyers with approved credit and financing through Southeast Toyota Finance. $29.04 monthly payment for $1,000 financed. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
Thinking of medical school? Edward Via College of Osteopathic Medicine in Auburn has award-winning medical education and research programs. VCOM partners with Auburn University for student activities, research, and sports medicine physicians to care for Tiger athletes. VCOM is providing tomorrow's physicians for Auburn and the surrounding communities. Find out more at vcom.edu. That's vcom.edu.
Second and goal for Auburn from the 5. We're waiting to see who comes in for Auburn at quarterback.
Peyton Thorne looks to
be
going back in.
It is Thorne going back in at quarterback. Damari Alston is the tailback.
Fairweather looks to be on the left side. Still in a three tight end set here, but Fairweather flanked out to the left, one-on-one.
Hooks and Fairweather. Hooks wide right, Fairweather wide left, the wide side of the field from the right hash.
Maybe look for a back shoulder throw or a tall throw right here to Fairweather on Irby for California.
Second and goal from the 5. Thorne from the shotgun. Alston behind him. Play action. They throw it to the end zone. Fairweather. Did he have it? He does. Touchdown, Auburn.
Yes.
Rivaldo Fairweather in the far side of the end zone. Pulls it in. Auburn takes the lead with 6:31 to go in the 4th.
Great play design right there by Coach Montgomery and Coach Freeze to split Fairweather out on the smaller Irby trying to hold him. Once you see the tight end flank out outside like that, he's 6'5", a big target. You expect him to throw that ball up high to give his guy a shot to catch that ball. Great play design. We saw it from the start. Great job by Auburn. Touchdown. Great finish on that drive.
Tigers take a 13-10 lead. This extra point attempt makes it more than a touchdown lead for the Tigers. McPherson on. The holder is Chapman. Quattlebaum the snap. The kick is on the way. The kick is good. 6 minutes, 31 seconds to go in the 4th. Auburn with the only score of the fourth or the second half thus far. Auburn 14, Cal 10. SeatGeek is now the official ticketing partner of Auburn Athletics. Whether you're buying or selling football tickets, SeatGeek is the place to do it. SeatGeek, so Tiger fans can fan. SunSouth, John Deere drive summary for Auburn. 69 glorious yards in 10 plays. 4 minutes and 37 seconds. Rivaldo Fairweather with his second huge catch on the drive. A 5-yard gem from Peyton Thorne. SunSouth, John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com.
Great throw right there by Peyton.
Can Auburn's defense come up one more time?
Yeah, this is the opportunity for Auburn defense to make a statement right here. You've got to flip the momentum of this game late in the 4th quarter. Let's see if we can get them 3 and out here, Andy.
Cal has all 3 of its timeouts remaining as McPherson booms it. And it's a fair catch by Cal. And the Bears will have 1st and 10 from their own 25. 6:31 to go. Cal has to get in the end zone. A field goal does not even tie the game with Auburn on top 14-10.
Yeah, great job of Coach Freeze and those guys going back to Fairweather. They missed him on the wheel route. Ball was kind of behind him. This time, Thorne put the ball up high. Once he split out, go up and make a high catch at the highest point. Great play design. Let's see if Auburn defense gets aggressive right here.
1st and 10 for Cal at its own 25. Jackson, the quarterback. Stredick, the tailback. A double tight end set for the Bears. Jackson from the gun. Stredick behind him. Jackson flips it out behind the tight end, Jack Endries, who was open in front of the Auburn sideline.
Yeah, Jackson tried to deliver that one too fast. His receiver head wasn't even turned around right there.
2nd and 10 for Cal. Clock stop with 6:28 to go in the 4th. Auburn 14, Cal 10. 2nd and 10 for the Bears. Bring Stredick into the backfield. Hand the ball to Stretic around the right side. Stretic forward out to the 33-yard line. He'll be a couple yards shy of a first down. And an Auburn player in the backfield is down. Is that Eugene Asante?
That's Donovan Coffin right there.
Number
he tried
five.
To come in and reach in and get the tackle. And he might have caught a leg to the, to the shoulder.
Yeah, he's lying face down. And the Auburn athletic training staff is out to tend to Donovan Coffin. Third and three, Cal, at its own 32. 6:16 to go in the fourth. Auburn 14, Cal 10. We'll get you an update on Donovan Coffin when we return. Auburn football continues in a moment.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
This is Coach Hugh Freeze. The support of the Auburn family is vital to the success of our student athletes, and On to Victory plays a crucial role in that. Please help keep that good work going by joining On to Victory today, War Eagle.
After the game, catch the Regions Bank postgame show. We'll have locker room interviews with players, assistants, and head coach Hugh Freeze, plus scores, highlights, and analysis, all on the Regions Bank postgame show. Show your Tiger pride and get a win for your wallet with the Auburn University Regions Visa debit card and the prepaid Regions Now card. Order now at regions.com/go Tigers.
You're listening to Auburn Football After Dark. Back to Berkeley for more of the Tigers and Bears from Cal Memorial Stadium.
Donovan Coffin got up and walked off under his own power and goes to the Auburn injury tent. Here is third and three for Cal at its own 33-yard line.
Taylor Wooten just checked into the game for Donovan Coffin. It makes me wonder, is something wrong with Keontae Scott? Well, they've been flip-flopping that position for the first two games.
Jackson, the quarterback. Stretic is the tailback. Cal needs 3 yards for a first down. From the right hash, Jackson out of the gun. Now brings a man in motion across the set. There's the snap. There's the handoff. Stretic stood up at the line. He might have lost a yard.
Man, big hit.
Larry Nixon, the third.
Yes.
And the punting unit comes on for Cal. A three and out for the Bears.
And I know we've been short of linebackers here tonight, but Larry Nixon, Asante, and Steiner has done an outstanding job tonight as a unit.
There's the kick. Fair catch called by Javarius Johnson, and he goes down. And he caught it at the 21. Well, there's a three and out for Auburn. The three and out tracker driven by Truckworks, official commercial truck dealer for the Auburn Tigers. 47-yard punt by Lachlan Wilson. And the most important offensive drive of the young season is coming up for Auburn. 5:24 to go in the fourth. Auburn 14, Cal 10. Cal has all three timeouts remaining. Auburn will scrimmage from its own 22.
Yeah, we would love to have a drive like we just had on that last series to take that ball down the field and work some of that clock.
Thorne, the quarterback.
Two tight ends sit here, Andy.
Jarquez Hunter, the tailback behind Thorne. First and 10 from the 22. Hand off to Jarquez. Bounces to the 25-30. He's to the 35 and out of bounds at the 39-yard line. Nope, they'll give him the 40. It's 18 yards for Jarquez Hunter.
Great job of being patient there, Andy, as well. He wanted to go fast, but he was trying to let his lineman get out in front of him so he can get out to open space. Great patience by Jarquez. That's an experienced running back.
Gave him to the 41, and the clock rolls. Remember, you go out of bounds. We're not inside 2 minutes yet. Under 5 minutes now to go in the fourth. Peyton Thorne looks to the Auburn bench for the call. Play clock at 13. First and 10, Auburn at its own 41. 4:47 on a counting clock in the fourth. Tigers 14, Cal 10. Thorne out of the gun. Turns, hands the ball, Jarquez Hunter. Hunter got a yard, maybe two.
The ball came loose there, but I think he was down, Andy. Let's hope he's down.
They're going to call him down, let's put it that way. We've had three reviews tonight. Two of them went Cal's way. They mark him down at the 43, and Hunter now will come out of the game, and Alston replaces Jarquez in the tailback.
They're going to stay in this two tight end set here, see if Auburn runs an RPO or try to hit a naked or a bootleg and hit one of the tight ends in the flat.
4:07 and counting in the fourth. Tigers up 14-10. Second down and eight for Auburn at their own 43. Timeout. Timeout called, and are they going to review the fumble?
The field,
oh, my.
As the runner is down by rules.
Oh, my.
The previous play is under video review.
My goodness gracious.
That's why I wonder why we were taking our time a little bit, not just getting up there and going.
Replay reviews are brought to you by Auburn's Houston Clinic. Don't let a sports injury bench you this season. Go to Houston for your fracture, sprain, or strain. Because orthopedics is all they do. Go straight to the specialist. Go to Auburn's Houston Clinic. We're taking a look at the replay along with the officials. Remember, the call was that he was down.
Yeah, it's going to be a close one, guy. Look at that right forearm right there. See if the knee hit the ground before that ball is loose.
Oh, boy. Cal thinks they're going to get the ball back.
Yeah, that ball's out there unless that right knee hit the ground first. That's why I wonder why Auburn went trying to go fast there.
Clock is stopped with 4 minutes in the fourth. The Cal faithful are convinced they're about to get the ball back at the Auburn 43-yard line. This is the biggest review of the young season.
Yeah, uncharacteristic of us tonight, Andy. We haven't put the ball on the ground last week against UMass, and tonight we put the ball on the ground three times already. At real speed, it looks like he's down, but then when you look at the slow pitcher, not sure if that right knee was down before that ball came out of his forearm.
We wait for the call from Daniel Gotra. He continues to look at the monitor.
Hope for the best, Auburn, but the defense got to be prepared here because it goes the opposite way to have to make
a
big stand.
Here comes the call.
After video review, the ruling on the field is overturned to a fumble. The ball be placed at the 41-yard line, first and 10, Cal.
Cal is given another life.
Yeah, it's going to be our biggest stand for our defense right here, Andy. Can they do it again? A sudden change. Can they stand tall and keep the Bears out of the end zone with 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter? Auburn has one timeout.
Four turnovers by Auburn tonight. Cal ball first and 10 at the Auburn 41. 4 minutes to go. Tigers lead 14-10. DeFonse is the tailback, flanking Jackson from the left hash mark. And comes in motion. Jackson drops to throw. Plenty of time. Throws to the boundary. It's complete and out of bounds at the 31. And a flag is down, and Auburn's going to get called for a hit out of bounds.
Kyan Lee got to know on that play right there. You get beat, just get the guy out of bounds, but don't do anything to tag on extra yards. You got to be smarter there if you're Kyan Lee in that situation.
It's going to be a first down and add 15 yards, I believe.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense, number 3. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, first down.
To the Auburn 15-yard line.
Yeah, we talked about the penalties and the turnovers. Just uncharacteristic last week of this team to come out tonight and have these turnovers. I just wonder if the late start has anything to do with it.
Monroe Young, Jeremiah Hunter split wide to the Auburn boundary. That's the wide side of the field. Ifanse, the tailback. Jackson, the quarterback, from the right hash. Ifanse with the carry. Ifanse, a flag is down. Ifanse stood up just inside the 15-yard line.
Yeah, it's going to come back. They got a hole on California right side.
Holding.
Right there.
Offense, number 71. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
Siawapa Vatakani. Stops a little bit of the Cal momentum and moves the ball back to the 25-yard line, where it will be first and 20.
Field goal doesn't hurt us here, Andy. Only a touchdown. Defense just got to be smart here, but still be aggressive.
Grizzell and Endries wide left, along with Hunter, the wide side of the field. Stretic, the tailback, flanking Jackson from the right hash mark. On first and 20 from the 25. Ooh, Stretic taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Man, Eugene Asante again.
Came flying in to get Stretic. And if he doesn't get Stretic, how big of a gain is that for Cal?
Yeah, he's probably hitting his head on a goalpost if he doesn't get that tackle.
1 yard gain. Second and 19 from the 24. Clock at 2:51 and counting in the fourth. Auburn 14, Cal 10. Cal with a bunch set to the short side of the field. Trips to the short side for the Bears. Jackson drops the throw. He throws it to the end zone to Hunter. It's incomplete. Over the head of Jeremiah Hunter.
Yeah, DJ James right there on the coverage, right there from the outside, squeezing that receiver of Hunter, making sure he can't get to that ball right there. Great job by an experienced corner, not to get a pass interference, but to cut him off a little bit from getting able to go get that ball.
Incomplete pass stops the clock with 2:35 to go in the fourth. Third and 19 for Cal at the Auburn 24. Right hash mark, double wide receivers right, the short side of the field, and left to the Auburn boundary.
You gotta expect this to be two down territory for Cal.
Man comes in motion to the near side. They throw it to the near side. It's caught by Endries. He's taken down at the 20-yard line. Just inside the 20, actually to the 22.
Great job, DJ James, fighting off the receiver Hunter right there and making that tackle on Grizzell. This is four down territory. They're going to go for it with 2 minutes and 17 seconds on the clock, knowing that they probably won't get the ball back.
This may be your ball game right here, friends. Fourth and 13 from the Auburn 18. They can get to the 5-yard line and a first down. Cal has all three timeouts remaining. Jackson to the line. Stretic, the tailback. Jackson now back at the shotgun. Ball at the left hash. Fourth and 13 for Cal. The snap to Jackson. He's pressured. He throws to the end zone. It's picked off in the end zone. Picked off in the end zone. DJ James.
Great job by the Auburn defense. Keontae Scott, I thought he was cramped up. He found a way to get back in this game late. Being able to chase down the receiver. DJ James falling back in coverage. Great interception. Great job by the Auburn defense. That may be a ball game, but they still have three timeouts there. First down's important.
Well, you got to take care of the ball. A minute 44 to go. Auburn first and 10 at its own 20. And a timeout on the field. 1:44 to go in the fourth. Auburn 14, Cal 10. Auburn ball when we come back at its own 20. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Hey y'all, this is Ronte, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the pimento cheese. I was like, go cheese, go pimento, go honey, go get it.
Hi, this is Chantrese, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the mild spiciness of the pickled jalapenos. No, it's the crispy chicken. Actually, I can't decide. It's the entire sandwich.
Order the honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Available for a limited time. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonials.
In football, it's important to call the right play. In life, it can be even more important to make the right call, especially regarding termite protection. To protect my home, I called Cook's Pest Control and got the Centricon system. You don't have to live with termites. For a free quote, make the right call. Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon system.
Looky, looky, looky. Here comes Cookie. Cook's Pest Control.
We've all fallen into boring routines. We just keep doing what has to get done. Isn't it time to escape the old routine and make time for yourself? Make time to go out with old friends. Make time to add excitement back into your life. Make time to feel like a winner again. Life is more fun when you live it. So what are you waiting for? Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
When the game goes into overtime, but the game goes into overtime, the choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Oh, what a big interception in the end zone for the Tigers by DJ James, the second of the night for Auburn. It's third of the season. That's another $1,000 for Children's of Alabama through the Picks for Kids program. Chick-fil-A donating $1,000 for each Tigers pick. That's three interceptions on the season. $3,000 for Children's of Alabama. Eat more chicken. War Eagle from Chick-fil-A. First and 10 Auburn at its own 20. 1:44 in the fourth. Cal does have three timeouts remaining. Robbie Ashford, the quarterback. Damari Alston is the tailback from the right hash. There's a ton of tight ends on the field right now for Auburn. Handoff goes to Damari Alston off left tackle, and Damari Alston gets 3.5 yards on the play.
Yeah, it's still important that Auburn get a first down here because they can take timeouts and they still have time on the clock to try to get the ball down the field.
Cal calls its first timeout of the second half.
Cal.
Stopping the clock with 1:39 to go in the fourth quarter. Auburn at its own 24-yard line. Second and 6 when play resumes. The Tigers lead at 14-10. Got to take care of the football here, Jason. That's been one of Auburn's biggest problems tonight.
Right. Yeah, that's uncharacteristic. I just wonder if the late start, I know it's not an excuse, but something changed here tonight. We're not taking care of the football.
The late start hasn't hurt the Auburn defense tonight, has it?
Right, it has not. Woo. Our defense has played aggressive, played lights out. Eugene Asante has got to be player of the game.
12 tackles on the night, 9 solo, a pass breakup, and 2 quarterback earns.
This is the same guy on the first day of school, rode around class with a full uniform on and helmets in 100-degree heat. So he doesn't get tired, Andy.
Second down and 7 now for Auburn is the official call. Alston behind Ashford. Ball in the middle of the field. Handoff goes to Damari Alston. He just covers it up and gets through out to the 27, make it the 28-yard line. Good carry, Damari Alston.
Yeah,
timeout.
Tough
and Cal uses its second timeout, and it's going to set up third down and a long three, make it a long three, a short two for Auburn right here.
Yeah, a lot of that right there was done by Damari Alston
on his
own. He ran it about 5 Cal Bears right there, and he just almost got loose there and picked up the first down.
Well, you could see him cover up with both hands, but he kept those legs a-churning.
Yeah, he showed the strength of his legs right there. Great job.
Real quick, let's head it downstairs. Cook's Pest Control sideline report, Will Herring.
Guys, this is why you have a guy like Robbie Ashford in your stable. You bring in that athletic quarterback. It's like having a 12th man on the field with his legs. And so look for the zone read here again for him to read whether to keep it or to give it. We're going to rely on these big nasties to pave the way. Let's see what happens.
Third and 2 for Auburn at the Tiger 28.
Got 2 tight ends here, Brandon Frazier and Luke Deal to the right side of the boundary here.
Ball inside the right hash mark. Ashford the quarterback, Alston is the tailback. Double wide receivers to the wide side of the field. Now one comes in motion near side. Handoff goes Alston. He's got the first down. He's across the 30. He's out to the 35.
That's going to be your ball game right there, Andy. Great play design to bring Camden Brown in motion to disguise the defense a little bit. And Damari Alston hit it in the hole. Great job by the offensive line.
And it forces Cal to burn its last timeout.
Yeah, the only thing Auburn has to do, I think, here is take 3 knees.
Take 3 knees and hold on to the football. Auburn has come west three times in the history of the program. Santa Clara in the 30s, USC when Smooth was the quarterback, and the championship game against Florida State at the Rose Bowl. Auburn has come up empty on those first three times.
And it's always an interesting end when we come out to the West Coast.
And this one isn't over yet.
Right.
Thorne now in at quarterback, and Auburn goes to a victory formation.
Best formation in football.
Thorne under center. Takes a knee. Just do it twice more, Auburn. And for the first time in the state of California, you will wing home a winner.
Yeah, great job by this team overcoming adversity. You learn a lot about your football team, Andy, when you can overcome adversity. This team faced a lot of adversity tonight, and the defense showed up and held its own. Offensively, we still got work to do, but you get a W out of this situation. That's a win in a lot of ways. A
lot of Cal folks heading home. The orange and blue celebrating in the south end zone. Thorne takes another knee. Auburn will only need to do it one more time, as our buddy Rod Bramble would say, night, night.
Put the lights out here in California and head back home.
Just take one more knee and start to celebrate, Auburn.
Yeah, I'm impressed with our linebacker core tonight.
Woo.
Coach Aldridge has got to be happy with those three guys, Steiner, Knitson.
There Nixon. It is. Thorne takes a knee, and Auburn will be victorious in the Golden State. And the Auburn team sprints to the Auburn fans and the Auburn band in the southeast corner. 5-4-3-2-1. That's an Auburn Tiger winner. Auburn 14, Cal 10.
Woo, what a game.
Buddy, you're not kidding. I pray you stayed up with us tonight.
Yeah.
Auburn goes to 2-0 on the season, home to face Samford next weekend. Auburn 14, Cal 10. Stay tuned. Auburn football continues in a moment.
Are you looking to advance your career without putting your life on hold? Consider the flexibility of an online MBA at Auburn University's Harvard College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best by U.S. News & World Report, our 100% online MBA program provides the flexibility you need to pursue a degree while maintaining your personal and professional life. Learn more at harvard.auburn.edu.
Hey, Auburn fans, it's Coach Hugh Freeze. Care teams at Ascension St. Vincent's care for the whole person. They know healthy lifestyles help prevent chronic illnesses, and cultivating a healthy lifestyle starts early. That's why we're partnering with them to sack obesity. For every Auburn sack, a donation is made to the Ascension St. Vincent Foundation to purchase PE equipment for schools around the state. Join Jill and me by making a donation to sack childhood obesity. Visit stvhsfoundation.org, War Eagle.
Hey, I'm Charles Barkley. Call for a Redmont and water at bars and restaurants throughout the great state of Alabama. Redmont Vodka, available at select ABC stores and package stores. Redmont Vodka is 8 times distilled, gluten-free, and is made from non-GMO corn. Looking to support a local business? Redmont Distilling is Alabama proud and minority-owned. Learn more online at redmontdistilling.com.
The Auburn players are celebrating with Auburn fans all over Cal Memorial Stadium as Auburn comes west to the state of California. And for the first time in school history, Auburn will wing home with a win. Tigers 14, Cal 10. We welcome you back to Berkeley along with Jason Campbell, Will Herring, Paul Ellen, Gene Dulaney, Brad Law, Patrick Tisdale, and Ben Harling. I'm Andy Burcham. Auburn shuts out Cal in the second half. Big defensive play after big defensive play, and one huge offensive drive in the second half, and the Tigers win it 14-10. Old Dominion presents Best in the Game. Old Dominion Freight Line works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to also be the best. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics. Jason, who or what is your best of the game tonight?
I can go with my best of the night is Eugene Asante. This guy was a tackling assassin tonight. He was all over the field making plays everywhere on the football field. He brought that energy tonight to a short-change defense, 12 tackles, total 9 solos, 1 sack. He came to play tonight, and my stop by the defense, they got the ball in the 41-yard line of Auburn right there in the fourth quarter after the fumble of Jarquez Hunter. And to get an interception in that situation, that was my top two of the game. Outstanding work by this defense and Coach Roberts. Outstanding game by Eugene Asante. Coach Aldridge, you have got to be happy as a linebacker coach.
No quitting about that. And then what Auburn's offense put together in the one touchdown drive that was both Robbie Ashford and Peyton Thorne at the quarterback spot. And Rivaldo Fairweather, we've talked about him all preseason, what kind of factor he can be. And he was a factor tonight for Auburn. 3 catches, 39 yards, including a 28-yarder on the drive. And then he closed it out with that 5-yard back shoulder throw from Peyton Thorne to give Auburn the lead, as it turns out, for good.
Yeah, Fairweather on those 2 huge catches, just like you just said, Andy. Once he spread it out to the field and he had Irby on him one-on-one, we just know that that ball is going to go to him and give him an opportunity. But like you said, it was an ugly game tonight offensively, but you found a way to get it done. At the end of the day, it's all about getting W. The drive to go win the game is what matters the most. We just got to move forward, learn how to protect the football. But at the end of the day, this team did a great job of finishing tonight and shutting out the Cal Bears in the second half. Great job by this defense.
Auburn is back at Jordan-Hare Stadium next Saturday night. It's a 6:30 start from the stadium. Auburn plays host to Samford. Our pregame coverage begins at 3:30 on a homecoming at the Auburn Tigers. It will be a victorious homecoming as Auburn comes home after tonight's 14-10 win against Cal. 6 o'clock kickoff, 3 o'clock airtime on the Auburn Sports Network. We've got much more coming your way from Cal Memorial Stadium, including interviews, analysis, highlights, and more on the Regions Bank postgame show. The general manager of the Auburn Sports Network has been Harling. Auburn football is produced by Brad Law. Our chief engineer, Patrick Tisdale. Quinn Burkeen has been our studio producer with assistance from Jay Neal. For spotter and statistician Gene Dulaney, and for Will Herring on the sideline, I'm Andy Bertram. So long and...